morning and welcome once again to Sports Talk. Glad to have you with us on a what looks to be maybe clearing up Saturday morning outside. Nice and cool, however, about 40 degrees on the way in this morning, but maybe we'll get some sunshine today. But looks like another soggy week ahead, as three or four days out of the next five or six supposed to be raining once again. But hey, all nice and dry, warm inside here in the studios, and hopefully you're warm and comfortable at home. Glad to have everyone with us this morning on Sports Talk. David Kiever along with Terry Reinhart, Kevin Hastings, Evan Ludwig, and maybe Jason Barber getting a limousine service from his private jet to the studio this morning. We'll be here momentarily. Always jets, it's foggy out. I mean, give him benefit of the doubt, jets can't land in the fog like we have out there this morning. So he'll be in a little bit. But glad to have everybody with us this morning. Plenty to talk about. We're going to run down, take a look back at last Saturday's state championship action in high school basketball. Take a look at this week in high school baseball and softball. One thing that might be a record happened this week in the state of North Carolina in softball. I know I've never heard of it before, but we'll check into it and see a little bit. Terry should know exactly what I'm talking about. And also, we'll check we're taking phone calls this morning from everybody that's 32-0 on their brackets. So far, the phone hadn't rang, but
I'm already here.
I didn't say 0-32. 32-0. But how about this? Well, you know, we had a couple upsets on the first day, and out of 11.5 million, it went down to like 2,700. You know, 0.04% by the time half a day was over, which is unbelievable. And now I don't know if anybody's got one perfect not near as many upsets yesterday as there was on day one. I think one lower seed is all that won yesterday, and that happened to be the Dayton Flyers, who in the opening night on Tuesday or Wednesday, whichever night it was they played, had to be Wednesday night since they played Friday, played on their home court.
They did.
How about that?
Amazing.
Got to play on their home court. That site had already been established as, and it is every year, I think, as one of the play-in games, Dayton, Ohio. And so they got to go out and play on their home court. I think they were actually the visiting team, if I'm not mistaken. So how confusing is that? We see that a lot in high school.
I don't like the extra four anyway. You know, you got 64 teams. How many of those are ever going to win it?
Yeah,
Dayton's still in it.
They ain't gonna win it. You'll put some money on that. Put some money down on that.
That's all that matters when they say, "Hey, they're only five away."
We're still alive, right? Still alive. And yeah, but you know, the bracket busters, and we'll talk about it. We want to go through this a little bit and see if we foresee any more upsets coming in the near future. I told Terry before we went on the air this morning, kind of odd. 27 out of 32 higher seeds won. So. Just not near as many upsets as we're used to in the first 2 days, but you couldn't convince folks from Baylor or Iowa State that there wasn't as many upsets, because they were two of the higher seeds, two of the three that got knocked out on opening day. And I told Terry I looked online and saw some of the names, and just by looking at the names, I won't get into this and why I think this, but the names that still have perfect brackets look to me like people that probably just don't follow basketball a whole lot and just went down there through their choosing names, because who in the world is going to pick both Baylor and Iowa State to get beat on the same day? I could see maybe somebody taking one upset there and that happening, but to go out there and on a limb and pick two upsets like that, especially – If their bracket is still perfect and they got all the other ones right, it's not like they were just, you know, picking upsets all along the way. They pick most of the favorites to win. But, you know, some people pick because they like the sound of the name better and things like that. So maybe that's what we got.
It's a crapshoot anyway.
It is.
I mean, nobody knows. I mean, people that think they know don't know. It's the first round, like I said, there's no difference between teams 25 and about 60. You just blew our ears up right there.
Yeah.
The microphone made a lot of noise.
Jason Barber in the house.
The flight is in. The limo has arrived, and the purple stripes are glowing this morning.
Looking like Kobe.
Look
over here.
We got the purple going on with Kevin with the Hornets and the purple with Jason.
Hey, we're a playoff team.
This morning, yeah. How about that?
We're a lottery team. Hey, I'll take it.
How about that?
At least in the West, we'll be a lottery team.
But what's you guys' record, really? You have any idea?
I only think the Lakers hit 20 games.
I'm talking about your bracket record.
Bracket record?
Oh, I don't even have a bracket. I didn't do it.
Going into the evening games, I had like 18 correct picks or something like that? So, okay.
Well, I'm 24-8.
But, I'm 21-11.
And there it is. And on this left side, mm-hmm. I missed two. Mm-hmm. Okay. Right, but over here, this bracket just destroyed me. With the likes of St. John's. I don't know why I picked St. John's to beat San Diego State. I picked this upset. I shouldn't have. Eastern Washington to beat Georgetown. Didn't happen. But I did go with the favorites in some of the games, like SMU, Iowa State. Didn't happen. And Davidson. I picked Davidson to upset.
Well, you probably thought to.
I picked Davidson as well.
I picked
well,
Davidson to win, and they got blasted by Iowa. I mean, not
they
just
couldn't
me,
hit no
they
threes.
Got blasted.
I mean, they've shot threes all year long, and then yesterday they could not put one down.
They missed Steph Curry. Duke,
they miss a lot of things.
You probably put St. John's in there, David, because you're so used to that matchup. That
they play each other
out.
A lot.
They came and, naturally.
Yeah, and
every year.
And not only. You know, that's why they're put in the position they are.
Yeah, it's been the first time St. John's played them in North Carolina.
Yep.
True. The committee likes to see those rematches of games that have already happened during the season. And don't know how many we got on here that could still happen. But
I want to go back to one thing, and that's when they first come out with these brackets. And I'm going to be honest, and I've got other people
one.
In here.
Count.
Here we go.
Just keeping count.
That's exactly right. when you come out with your number one seeds, three of your number one seeds should have been there, but the other one shouldn't. And I'm sorry. I can go with Kentucky. I can go with Villanova. And I can go with Wisconsin. But I had a hard time putting Duke in as a number one. And the reason being because they didn't win a regular season. They didn't win a tournament. They didn't win nothing. How in the world you put them? You'd had to put Arizona in as a number one ahead of them, and I have a problem with that. And I know Duke fans are going to say, "Oh man, you're about crazy." Well, I might be, but
well,
you know,
you are. Besides,
yeah,
Terry is crazy, but he's right on this one.
I mean, I have a hard time with them being number one. Either Virginia should have took it, and they're going to say, "Well, we beat Virginia." Well, you didn't beat Virginia in the regular season. You did not win the regular season title. You finished on down below them.
Why do you think the committee did decide to put Duke as the one?
I'm going to be honest
Mike
with you.
Krzyzewski's the coach.
Well, yeah, I do too. I think that's the only reason.
I'm okay with that.
But, yeah, you take it.
Because
right.
I don't want to hear the committee come back and tell me it's on account of Anderson was hurt. Well, you know what? They played like the last six or seven games without Anderson and still won.
Okay, what if somebody uses this argument? And I'm not saying I disagree with you, really, because I could see it being a number of teams being in that spot. But let's just say – Duke had the best road wins out of any of the 4-1 seeds.
Okay. Did you win a regular season? Did you win a title?
They won.
Tournament title.
They won. Okay. Is Duke the first team to ever do
– First team ever.
Out of any conference?
1979, the only team ever that said it in the first article. And that when the
I told you earlier in the week, it goes to show you, and it shouldn't be this way, regular season championships mean nothing.
Nope.
Yeah, well, the tournament didn't either.
If you're Notre Dame, how do you look at your guys and say, "Hey, man, you're the champions. Congratulations. You get nothing."
Right. And where did Virginia? You know
what you get is a banner.
You get a banner.
I mean,
and
I had no
awesome.
Trouble.
You can go back and say, "Hey, we won that banner."
Yeah. The only one that I would have changed, I would have put Duke as a number two, that, no doubt about that, but Arizona should have been in there as another number one.
So you'd have put Arizona over Virginia.
I think it's a toss-up between those two. I like Arizona over Villanova, really. But
Arizona's a better team. I think Michigan goes – I mean, I think Virginia goes down tomorrow.
Yeah,
I do, too.
I think Michigan State.
Michigan State.
Yeah, that's who I
picked
that.
So if
everybody's picking that in their brackets, that means Virginia's going to win
by
20.
Probably. but let me ask you this. If you're on the committee, and all right, I'm just going to go on Virginia right now, and you think they're going to get beat in the second round, why would you give them a one?
Who thinks? I mean, you're the only one that thinks they're going to beat the second round.
No, well, you just heard three out of four.
Well, y'all might be wrong there.
Here's your deal.
I've been wrong before, and I admit it, but you won't.
Well, then why would you have put Virginia down there then? I mean, you know, there's already a reason. If you rearrange it and Duke goes to a number two, then Arizona would have moved up. And that might have replaced Virginia in another bracket somewhere.
Well, they probably do.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I know. Yeah. But I'm just saying, if you think they can't beat a team like Michigan State, who's a 7, you know, if they were matched up that way.
Well, I go by how they're playing now.
Well, and
you know,
basically the committee, they're looking at the team's last 10 games, basically. It's what
Terry,
okay.
You just contradicted yourself.
No, I did
totally.
Not. No, I did
yes,
not.
You did.
Because
you said go by how they're playing now.
Okay.
So what does a regular season championship mean then?
It does mean a lot. I did not say that. But Virginia got beat in the same thing that Duke got beat in the tournament.
So
same day.
Okay.
So I mean, that game, that I'm not contradicting myself.
You said yes, you did. You said it's all about what you do now. No. And just a minute ago, you said about regular season championship.
Yeah, the championship should mean something.
Okay. So what if you win 15 games the first month in the conference and then lose your last four, but you're still conference champion?
I guess then your conference was terrible if you lost at the very end because anybody could catch you.
Well, that's the one. Then you're just speaking of Virginia because
there you go. That's what I'm saying.
They lost two of the last three conference games.
You can't have it every way, Terry. It's one or the other. Do you want regular season or do you want how you're playing now?
I just don't see.
We're still overlooking.
We talked about this earlier in the season, and I pointed out that Duke was sixth in the conference at one time, ranked fourth in the nation.
Half the teams.
You don't win the ACC, like we said, it's the first time ever it's happened that a team did not win one of the conference championships and got a number one seed.
Well, I know what cost Virginia was their out of conference schedule.
They're still a champion.
It was weak. Now Arizona, I haven't really looked.
Now let's reverse this. Let's say Duke wins the regular season championship, they get beat in the tournament with the same record as Virginia.
They would have not dropped.
Would they be the number
one? No, they would have not dropped. They'd have still been a number one.
Okay. That's my point on that. The name does matter at some point. So these in college
sports. Do you think it helps North Carolina the same?
It absolutely does. I was going to say the same thing.
They've
got 11 losses and they're ranked
14. I'm not saying it don't. I think it helps Kentucky the same.
They built up that benefit of doubt.
I think it helps Kansas the same.
Yeah.
Roy and Coach K, it depends on these coaches. You know, like Jason said, they've built it up. I mean, Calipari, all of them, they've built it up. I think it hurts worse in the preseason rankings in football than it does anything. Mm-hmm. The basketball, you can make up for. You win the tournament, don't matter your rankings, but football just kills you.
I just got a text once if we work for the NCHSAA that maybe insinuating that they seed similar.
Well, I mean, you know.
you asked about my tournament record. I'm looking good so far as total, correct? 25-7.
Yeah, you're one above me.
Nobody at the NCHSA has a map of the state of North Carolina. That's what's funny.
Yeah. And I'm going to tell you how come I look at this, but and not to go off on Carolina, but they kept giving Carolina like a four seed. Well, State jumps in there all the way at number eight, but State was on like a bubble line. Well, you look at the total records. Okay, Carolina's losses are almost what State's is.
What Notre Dame got, a three?
Notre Dame got a three seed.
Ranked eighth in the country, won the ACC tournament, got a three seed. So, I mean, eight, that puts you at a two seed
once
right
again,
there.
But once again, what the committee is looking at is what's Notre Dame's rep when it comes to the tournament time.
Oh.
They're usually one and done, two and done. That's
but you shouldn't do that, really.
They do.
No. Should be. Every team every year should be considered, you know, it's a different year, it's a different team.
That's why I prefer them being in NFL.
Remember, the committee is made up of college ADs, former coaches, so there you go.
Anytime there's a committee involved, something's bad's going on.
Yeah, I was mad the first time the bracket come out. I'm like, this is totally wrong. There's no way Duke's a number one.
Yeah,
and I can't argue that. I mean, I could have seen them easily being a two, one of the, you know, maybe as a five overall or the six overall.
I could have seen them
but
being a two.
I haven't checked it out. I want to go in here and look at Arizona's season schedule and see. You know,
they probably won their regular season. They probably won their tournament.
I'd like to see if they had any key out of conference wins. I don't know if they go to the East Coast and play anybody or
they did beat San Diego State 61-59 and they beat Gonzaga in overtime 66-63.
Gonzaga, when I give to you, that's a pretty good win.
Biggest win of the year. They beat Gardner Webb. They beat Clemson.
Arizona played Gardner Webb this year.
Yeah, they beat Utah. They beat Oregon. They beat Arizona State.
But they did lose to Oregon State.
Kansas State, Missouri. I don't know how good they are.
And they got a pretty tough matchup against Ohio State. Ohio State could be a sleeper pick.
They could.
Okay, but now when you start talking about losses, okay, then people are going to say, okay, Duke lost to Miami.
Right, at home.
You know?
At home. I mean, I could see it different ways. I'll tell you one thing I think we would agree on. Kentucky's the one seed.
Yeah.
That's for sure.
Here's my thing.
And I mean the one.
Here's the thing about the Duke. Somebody on that committee should have looked around the room and said, hey, guys, no team in the history of this bracket has ever got a one seed without winning this. Do they really, really, really deserve? Somewhere. Are they the number one team in the ACC?
It's name recognition.
I know.
It's TV ratings.
I know.
who's probably one, the two biggest draws for the NCAA tournament will be Duke, Kentucky. If you look at the brackets for both sides, they're basically trying to give them a road to get to the Final Four to have that head.
And I do feel bad for Virginia because, you know, I mean, what will it take? Mm-hmm. And, you know,
it's probably going to take another year before someone actually believes in them. They can do this one more.
They get hammered for their ugly style of basketball.
Yeah, that's it. Yeah.
But they win.
Yeah, that's true.
And you wonder if that style of basketball played into
them. I got a text talking
played
about
– played into them not getting
somebody want to know about Duke's easy bracket, too. Not only do they get number one, the road to the Final Four, they say, well, they got Georgetown or Utah maybe.
Wow.
Then they maybe have to play Iowa or Gonzaga.
But you know what? I came in to talk to you, Kevin, on Monday or Tuesday last week, and I agreed with you. I thought it was the easiest bracket. ESPN, strongest bracket.
Really?
They rated it the strongest bracket.
Did they let Duke Vitale vote all across the board on
but
that?
But I know a lot of people talking about, like, if Georgetown
is
down.
Imagine having the hatred that Kevin has for one program.
it's the unfairness of this. I'm just making points. I didn't say anything bad. I didn't say any hate. I'm just making points. If the facts sound like hate.
Well, then when you look at their bracket and you say, okay, there's Iowa State who thopped.
No, it's not. Well, yeah,
you know, they went down. And there's UCLA. Nobody thought they'd beat SMU.
Right.
Yeah.
Right.
There's another thought.
Can't help the upsets.
No, that's
happen.
Not Duke's fault.
No.
But
it is Duke's fault. They're in their bracket.
They always play the games in front of.
But this Carolina fan.
Hey, I hope it is. I'll take it.
This Carolina fan said, and it's Carolina's fault for losing 11 games. But if Carolina wins, they have to beat Wisconsin, Arizona, and Kentucky just to get to the finals. So, but it is a tougher road, you know, if you don't have a good season. But yeah, just Carolina fans making points against each other there.
And I mean, you know, and that is a tough bracket. I'll agree, having to beat those three quality teams who all match up pretty good against Carolina.
Well, they don't. They're not going to win it anyway. Bracket. They don't have a chance. I'm sorry, I'm a Carolina fan, but come on, guys, come on.
You know what? It all depends on for them. It's funny how what Carolina's counting on is what Duke is counting on. They got to shoot the ball well outside.
Yeah.
Because they've got the inside game.
Well, if they remember to go to it.
They got to shoot the ball well outside.
Teams that have historically beat Carolina are teams that have one three-point shooter that just goes out of his mind.
And then in the Virginia game, how many
threes did Carolina hit?
They went off. Yeah, Justin Jackson hit five. See, hit
I mean,
four,
that,
five,
that's the difference in their game.
Well, they play. Well, David, they played 35 games. That was one.
Well, I know, but it was against a good defensive team.
Blind squirrel finds another.
And you have to hope things get better. I mean, you don't have to hit that many, but you have to hope things get better.
If they keep Nate Britt off the floor, anything's possible. They can go all the way.
And don't get me wrong, as a fan, I am an ACC fan.
Got to be Arkansas
so,
first. We didn't even mention that. Yeah.
When you look at the bracket, when you look at the bracket now, and they took three ACC teams and stuck them in one area. Now, I did not like that. Why did you do that?
Usually you won't go with more than two.
You know,
and what they do.
You got State, Louisville, and Virginia all in the same one.
Which is another, to me, another X for Virginia winning the regular season and being stuck in with two conference teams. But I would have took one of those out. I'm with you.
Well, they should have. One of them should have been stuck over there in that Kentucky division.
Yeah, I'm with you. I don't understand that. To me, as long as there's spaces available, spread them out till you run out of space.
Yeah, I'm surprised.
Oh, never mind. Notre Dame's in the Midwest.
I'm surprised they didn't put them in the.
A lot of people forget their ACC. It's easy.
I'm surprised they didn't put Louisville in the same region with Kentucky. However, they couldn't have opened up in the same spot because it would have been a home game because Kentucky played in Louisville.
One thing we haven't mentioned, ACC 6-0.
Yeah, first round. And the Big 12 is –
The Big 12 is stinking.
Everybody was saying they were the best conference coming in.
But the ACC being 6-0, I mean, that's – I don't know if they've ever gone undefeated on the first 2 days. If they have, it's been a long time.
It's been a while.
It probably when you had less teams in it, too. I mean, it's easier to go 2-0 or 3-0 than it is 6-0.
And I want to tell you another reason they're doing this. Since the ACC has went to this thing, when you go look at the all-time winningest programs, UNC comes in at number 3, Duke's number 4, Syracuse is number 5, and Notre Dame is number 9, Louisville is 11, North Carolina State's number 25.
Is this an NCAA tournament wins or just
total wins total ever?
Really?
You know, you're talking about a power conference. The ACC is up at the top of the line.
Is that since the NCAA tournament started?
This is since the all ACC combined total wins by any school. Kentucky leads the way, Kansas is second. You know, and then Carolina, Duke, Syracuse.
Does that count Syracuse's minus 108 wins?
Yeah. Probably not.
Do we need to drop it down a couple spots?
Probably it might, but we'll count them for now. We'll count them until they make us erase them. But, hey, you know, we're going to take a time out here in just a second. But one thing we've got to get into, you know, the first round of the NCAA tournament is fun. Mm-hmm. But today and tomorrow, to me, are the best 2 days of the whole NCAA tournament. I just think that these next 2 days are just unbelievable because we'll see a lot more close games. Day one had 5 1-point games, yeah, which is the first time ever.
Set a record. There was quite a few records as far as even 10 points or less, games 10 points or less.
And, you know, you don't have to have a one-point game for it to be a classic because most of those classics end with, you know, 2, 3, even 4 points, you know, different things. But it's odd just to have that many one-point games. And I wonder how many shots were taken at the end of those games, you know, that didn't go in. That could have made it go.
Just state ask, shot went in.
Well, right, state's went in. How many did go in? How many didn't?
I know.
In those last 10 seconds. We'll take a break, come back with more sports talk here in a moment. She looked at him with those soft eyes.
The money you save in your savings accounts earns interest. So it just makes sense to have your checking account also earn interest for you. A money market checking account pays interest and also offers the flexibility of writing checks. Certain fees may apply. Carolina Trust Bank, member FDIC. Community-minded just like you. Community-minded
just like you. What's up, Doc?
Well, that crazy rabbit is back with this year's Bunny with the Money. Someone will win $1,000 again this year. Register to win with no obligation to buy. At Ferguson Ace Hardware, Highway 150 in Cherryville. At Dallas Express Pharmacy on North Hoffman Street, Dallas. At Accutrol Income Tax Service on West Main Avenue in Gastonia. At Amity Finance in downtown Kings Mountain. At Abernathy Chrysler Jeep Dodge on East Main Street, Lincolnton. At Carpet One Interiors on East Ozark Avenue, Gastonia. You can also register to win at Shelby Hardware, South Lafayette Street, Shelby, at Allen Drugstore, downtown Stanley, at Mitchum's Kitchen in Vail, at Basic Finance on East Dixon Boulevard in Shelby, and at S&R Auto Sales on Highway 180 South in Shelby. Register to win the Bunny with the Money. The drawing will be held Friday, April 3rd at 8:30 a.m. on Big O Country.
Mr. Sparky, we're on time, you'll see. Mr. Sparky, all your repair is free.
Back with Rusty Wise from Mr. Sparky. You told me about this top 10 list of things people said they couldn't live without, and food and water wasn't even on there.
It was things like cell phone, microwave, internet service.
Well, that's why it's kind of nice to know Mr. Sparky offers generators.
Yes, Mr. Sparky offers Generac generators. We're an elite dealer in the Charlotte market. We can service, repair, and do the install and offer financing also. The generator system comes on by itself, monitors the utility, and when the utility power comes back on, the system turns off. You don't have to do a thing. If you currently have a generator system, let us come out and make sure it works properly.
Mr. Sparky, we're on time, you'll see. Mr. Sparky, all your repair is free.
If you lost power for a day or more, where would you be?
Don't put it off. Call Mr. Sparky, 888-8-SPARKY.
You don't have to put up with any malarkey. Call 888-8-SPARKY.
Do you have a lot of old medications piling up? Well, most people do. Then get rid of them and do it safely. Drop off your old medications at the new medication drop box located inside Falston Pharmacy in Falston. All medications will be disposed of by the Cleveland County Sheriff's Department. It's easy. Just clean out your medicine cabinet, bring them in the Falston Pharmacy, and drop them in the box. Falston Pharmacy, Highway 18 north of Falston.
The Transportation Administration of Cleveland County and Cleveland County Transit would like to take this time to remind everyone that drugs like marijuana, alcohol, prescription drugs, and inhalants are the drugs of choice among our teens. They break hearts, break homes, and destroy childhood dreams. It's not just someone else's child, it could be yours. If you're not talking to your children about drugs, doesn't it make you wonder who is? TAC and Cleveland County Transit would like to wish all of our Cleveland County school athletic teams good luck this year. Jamma G's Pizza Factory is Shelby's favorite locally owned family pizza restaurant, featuring a pizza buffet and salad bar, a fantastic game room, and birthday parties. Jamma G's has gluten-free pizza, vegan cheese pizza, and now try the La Nova Wings in barbecue, hot and spicy, or oven roasted. And Jamma G's is the original home for the Livermust Pizza. Want to eat at home and watch the game? Call for carryout at 704-600-6182. Jim and Jay's Pizza Factory, Highway 74 East, behind the Golden Corral in Shelby.
There you go, Ann. Your new account is now open. Just one more little thing.
Here's your card.
What was that?
It's my new bank. Every time I turn around, I get hit with another fee.
You need to get an account at Carolina Federal Credit Union.
She's right.
Tired of getting hit by bank fees? Switch to Carolina Federal Credit Union today. Make those pains go away.
Here's your receipt.
David, Jason, Kevin, Terry with you in the studio Saturday morning. Heading into more NCAA basketball today. Can't wait to get the games underway today. Are we a 12 o'clock start today again?
Yes.
Basically from 12 to 9 o'clock. Yeah.
And we got all kind of Carolina fans that call in about this stuff.
All the games on KTC broadcasting, 1390 a.m., 1050 a.m., and 1590 a.m. What you can't do, guys, is stream on our website, NCAA stuff. You can't do that.
Prohibits.
You have to go to their website to stream online. So we can't stream it. So if you are going to listen to it in the car or at home with your radio, 1050 a.m., 1390 a.m., and 1590 a.m.
So no streaming via smartphones either on the tune in.
Well, you can not on our website. Right. If you can tune into the Go Heels network or whatever other network you want. You can CBS. Their online stuff and listen to the games there, but not through us online. So just do want to make that point before someone calls complains. But today I do want to talk real quick. 5 o'clock, we do have a special broadcast today of high school basketball. I know basketball season's over, and we're just going to talk about that here in a few minutes. But real quick, I've got the teams and stuff here we can go over later. But the 1A West and Midwest All-Star game is today. It's a basketball game, girls and boys. Girls play at 5, boys at 6:30. That's at Cherryville's Nixon Gym tonight, folks. So if you want to see a good basketball game, this is the All-Star game of the 1A teams. The West versus the Midwest, and it will be at Nixon Gym tonight, 5 o'clock girls, 6:30 boys. Some of the local teams in the area, let me pull that up so you know. There's about 7 teams from up in the mountains, and the Midwest teams includes it's pretty much the Southern Piedmont 1A schools, Lincoln Charter, Community School of Davidson, Highland School of Tech, Cherryville, Thomas Jefferson, Pine Lake Prep, Mitchell High's on the Midwest team, Piedmont Community Charter, in Avery County and Bessemer City. Highland Tech for the boys will have Dominic D. Cherryville will have Ryer Davis and Grant Henderson in the game. Highland Tech will also have Thomas Nieman. Bessemer City will have Southern Piedmont Player of the Year Asante Sanders and also Quan Wright. Cherryville coach Scott Harrell will be the head coach, assisted by Bessemer City coach Danny McDowell and Thomas Jefferson coach Ken Hines. For the girls, real quick, they'll be playing, like I said, at 5 o'clock. Now, folks, you can listen to this game, if you can't make it to the game, on 1590 a.m. today and online. You can listen to that on the stream today. Well, you won't even be listening. If you go to the stream today, you'll be watching. That's my other point. You can actually watch this game, folks, if you can't make it out to the court, online on ktcbroadcasting.com. Me and Calvin Hastings and Smoke will have the coverage. We're going to have pictures of it, too. So you can watch the replay if you can't catch it live on YouTube and see the pictures on our Facebook page. Real quick, for the Midwest girls, Highland School of Technology, Madison Armstrong, I think she was the player of the year in the Southern Piedmont 1A. Angela Bruton from Bessemer City, also from the area, Madeline Holmes and Caitlin Miller of Lincoln Charter, Bree Ramsour of Cherryville High School, and make sure I didn't skip anyone else in our three counties. I don't think I did. And the rest of them, of course, like I said, Mitchell High School, Pine Lake Prep, some of these other charters in the Southern Piedmont 1A. The West teams will be made up of Blue Ridge, Cherokee, Hayesville, Highlands, Hawassee Dam, and Robbinsville. And last, I didn't mention the coaches for the women's, for the girls.
Games today, right?
Two games.
Girls
at 5.
Boys. Girls get underway at 5.
Boys immediately boys after. You after can that. Watch the game, like I said, online at ktcbroadcasting.com or on your smartphones. Coaches for the girls are Kim Gordon of Pine Lake Prep, Franklin Lowry of Lincoln Charter, and J.J. Stamey of Bessemer City High School. It'll be good seeing J.J. again. He played a year before me there at Bessemer. He's a pretty good ball player.
So interesting. I wonder how this came about.
I guess Coach Carroll might call in later or give us a text and everything. From what I've been told is you know these East West All Star games, they don't feature the 1A schools much. It's a good way to promote the 1A athletes.
That's a good point.
There's a lot of these kids in these 1A 2A schools that don't get the promotions as they should, especially over here in the West. Because you know, I mean, like we said earlier, some people in charge of North Carolina stuff don't think the West
goes past
Winston-Salem. You know, it doesn't go past Winston-Salem. So a lot of these kids don't get the recognition we do. That's a lot of the things that we like to do with KTC in these small schools. I mean, you'd never have some of these coaches and scouts from across the country, from wherever. You never know when someone's watching one of these games. You remember last year in the Legion game, Legion State Tournament, how many scouts? We had the Western head coach, I think, was watching online because we were broadcasting online because the assistants called and said, hey, guys, you can watch this game online. So, I mean, these coaches do watch our games across the country online and see these kids playing ball, and it's a good way to scout and an easy way to see them. And so we're proud of that any way we can help out. So that we're helping out with the broadcast to get these kids online and let some of these people see these ball players.
Looking forward to that. That should be very interesting today, getting all those good players together.
5 o'clock right girls, 6:30 boys. Listen on 1590 AM. You can watch on ktcbroadcasting.com.
Also, while we're on high school sports, let's just go through a few topics. Last week's state championships, East Lincoln boys fell for the first time this season. Fall to the high and mighty and powerful Kinston team that won their fourth straight state championship.
Five in the last seven. They won.
I think it's five out of
eight
seven.
Eight of the last ten. They just kept on. They just kept on going. Yeah.
We know 11 out of the last 100.
Well, I mean, I just thought it was interesting. They already had the papers printed up when they won it in the fourth quarter. They're holding
Brian
up four
Hanks
in a row.
We should thank Brian Hanks for that, huh? Remember he tweeted us last week. He said 24-1 wouldn't be a bad year for East Lincoln. So.
Well, Kinston would clearly prove why they are four-time defending state champions. I mean, they're just really solid.
They are, and in East Lincoln, it was one of the things I was concerned about the whole year, just seeing them. They reminded me so much of the teams that I played with and saw at Cherryville back in the late 90s and early 2000s that, you know, once you get to that level – height matters a lot. You can dominate
in depth,
like Jason said. You know they had injury problems and height problems. You know, once you get there, you run into 1.69 kid, 1.68 kid, and everybody on your team 6'2". Mm-hmm. You might have five better ball players than them, and they got one kid that you just can't stop. And Kinston wasn't like that. They had a couple. Everybody on their team was 6'5". So it's just when you get that far, there's always something that it ends up being your Achilles heel.
I thought one thing about them that was nice, they didn't try to do everything through the big guy, through the
superstar. No, they didn't.
He touched it on most possessions, but he dished it out a lot. He didn't try to score all the points.
He got hot. He
was the difference in the game.
It's the difference when, you know, you're taking a shot and he's not going to have a shot contested really at all. And then Sage is getting his three-point shots thrown into the second row of the bleachers over our heads. How many three-pointers do you think Sage has had blocked this year? And they had, what, two or three in that game? Probably. I mean, it's just –
maybe he may
it's
have
hard.
They were all Saturday.
Yeah, it's hard when you go up against the length like that.
But I'm going to be honest with you now. During the game, they was one stretch, and me and Jason all sat there and thought it was 38-32 with about 4 or 5 minutes to go in the third quarter. That it stayed that way for 4, 5, 6 trips down the court. And if they had scored, but after that, then Kinston went on like a 7 or 8-0 run and put the game away. Yeah. But if they had scored in them trips down,
they were like a notch on a stereo. They turned it up one notch on defense every quarter.
Yeah.
You know, they laid back in the first and the second. They met you at half court. In the third, they come three-quarter court. In the fourth, they met you all the way. Yeah. And they also play with much more intensity.
And they went to trap. They
That's
went
the
to
way
the
their
trap
games defense. Have gone this year.
Well, 2-1-2 traps.
And back to my point on that, once you get to that level, East Lincoln this year averaged, what, 80, 85 a game?
Oh, yeah.
The last three games, 50, 50, 50. So, I mean, 40, 40. Yeah. You know. You scored in the 40s and the 50s. It's a totally different ball game that they're not used to, they ran into a bus saw that was a little bit taller than them. I think if East, you know, I think they would have had an even better game if Duggins was in there, just because they had a lot of corner option threes. I don't know if y'all noticed that they were wide open, but Valentine really don't shoot that shot. He'd get it. have to kick it back out. If Duggins is there, you know, he might hit two or three threes. You never know.
Keeps him in the game.
What a great season.
A little more height.
The final four games and the Elite Eight games, I mean, just the comebacks that they made. I mean, what a great season from East Lincoln.
Tremendous two seasons back-to-back with football and basketball.
You mentioned, Terry, that stretch there. What it was, those that don't remember, in the third quarter, East Lincoln came out, tied the game up at 28. Mm-hmm. And then Ingram went on a 10-0 run by himself in like 2 minutes.
He did.
And then East Lincoln cut it 38-32 and had like three straight possessions where they had fast breakaway layups and couldn't score while it was 38-32.
They missed how many layups in that game, guys?
I mean, I don't know.
5 to 10 layups plus the free throws they missed. I mean, they were – Chaz was 3 of 18.
Yeah, I hate to say that.
If he goes
9 of 18,
they're down by one.
Mm-hmm.
Yep. That's just 2 points. That's not
but
if
I think
got a three or any
when they
shots.
Were driving to the to the goal, they were worrying about their shot getting blocked
instead of
just laying it straight in.
Well, Terry, in their defense, and from what I noticed in that game, the Final Four game and the game before it, and David might be able to test this, and Jason, y'all were up there too, how many times when they would drive to the basket, there was body contact? They never called the body contact.
Yep.
So when you're smaller than people, that's one of your weapons to go against the taller player is go into them.
Yep.
And if they're not calling that, then your shot just gets beat back in your face, and you're just like, well, I mean, what can I do?
Try to draw the foul, and it wasn't happening.
It wasn't. I mean, it's like once they got to that point in the tournament, it's like the refs that aren't used to these teams, I don't know if they're not used to these teams or if it's a different style of play, is that the body calls going to the basket were not being called at all. It was everything on the block shot calls.
Well, I'll tell you one call they did follow.
Or a reach out at the top of the key.
It was a charge. How many charges were called in that? Because there was quite a few charges called.
The one against Smoky Mountain, I've never seen a team flop so much except watching Duke. I mean, it just doesn't happen. That was as bad. I'm sorry. David gives me the look.
Hey.
They were even wearing Duke's old uniforms. They just unstitched the D off the side. They were blue and white, looked exactly like them.
But you talk about confidence, and we saw it, you know, where they had all the shirts printed. They were tossing them out
before
the game's
over.
Oh,
yeah.
I saw
papers, daggum, already printed. So you're talking about being believable.
And that says a lot because you were playing an undefeated team.
Yeah.
That's what
they believed they was going
to
win.
The audacity to come in that gym against an undefeated team with printed out papers and T-shirts already. I mean, that's
When you've been there 3 years, prior to that, and you won all 3 years.
And also, they lost to 2 private schools this year out of state.
Yeah.
And also a 4A Millbrook team
and a rival Goldsboro. And one of those private schools they lost to, Montrose, one of their most famous alums, Kevin Durant.
Jerry
Stackhouse was sitting behind the bench for Kent, and a lot of people got in there and got getting autographs and stuff. I walked by him, tapped on the shoulder. Hey, Jerry. He's like, hey. And I said, you're not down here pulling for Kinston, are you? We've got plenty of seats down here in this East Lincoln, bitch. Come on down. And, of course, you know, he's from Kinston and everything. So he thought it was funny. He said, nah, man, I'm good right here.
But Quentin Copel's
there. He talks so country. He's just he's such a nice guy. I saw Rodney Rogers there, too. Him and Jerry worked together on that summer pro-am league. Where's that at? We were talking about that.
They have it in Durham. It's in Raleigh-Durham area right there. They have it.
I was telling David about that. Guys, you got to go to that. That's one of the – it's free. You just walk in. You see a lot of
pros.
Yeah.
A lot of college Carolina, the Duke, the State kids will come. They'll go over there and play.
It's like watching Duke and State Carolina pickup games and sprinkled in with some pros and stuff here and there. I saw John Wall 1 year play.
Rasheed Wallace still plays in it.
You want to see some smack talking Rasheed – every time at the gym, the whole thing, it just explodes when he walks in the gym.
I want to say it's held in Durham, and it may be at North Carolina Central.
That's exactly what it is. I couldn't remember which one of the schools it was there in Durham. Like I said, we went down a couple times, and it's really, really, really neat to sit there and see the pros that up that close.
Here's one thing that happened last week that I never remember happening before.
What's that?
The girls were swept, all four, by the West teams. The boys, the East teams, swept all four games. I never remember it being that way before.
Neither.
And in the past, you know, the West has generally come out on top, I think. And I read maybe 10 out of the last 14 years the West have had more wins, but this one split right down the middle. We saw a great one when we walked in. Wilkes Central beat Kinston girls 44-41 for the 2A championship. That was followed by the boys' championship game at the Smith Center. Kinston beat East Lincoln 60-43. Myers Park girls, nationally ranked, still disagree with the decision to not let them go play in New York in a tournament, but they beat Southeast Raleigh 52-47.
I don't know anything about that. What happened?
And Myers Park. Garner beat Audrey Kale 70-64. At Carmichael, Winston-Salem Prep girls were a winner, 58-31. I think I heard a lot of 1A boy coaches in the state of North Carolina cheer this one, though. East Carteret Public School beat Winston-Salem Prep in the boys' title game 67-61. Yes. Hickory Girls proved that they are the best 3A, if not the best girls' team in the state, period. I'd love to see them play Myers Park. Hickory beat Chapel Hill 71-53. And Terry Sanford knocked off Ashbrook. Ashbrook, another one. Congratulations on a great season that you had. Run all the way to the title game. 67-60, Terry Sanford wins. But you were asking, Myers Park was invited to a national tournament, and North Carolina High School Athletic Association don't allow anybody to play over their limited games. It's not the fact that they couldn't go there and play. They can if they haven't gone to their limited games. It was appealed twice, and the ruling was upheld twice. So Myers Park will not be going to New York to play in the national tournament.
Once again, the state of North Carolina prohibiting the state of North Carolina to get shine on the national level.
Come on.
I mean, you look at ESPN, you're not just talking about basketball, but you have football, how publicly, you know, ESPNU football, high school football games are being on TV.
It's not that often we have teams that good on a national level. Why not, in these cases, just make a waiver, this, you know, say it's a one-time thing.
And if it comes on again in 10 years,
mm-hmm. let's do it again. If a team is good enough on a national level to get invited to one of these things, man, let them shine in the spotlight.
I guess schedule one less game, everybody. So just in case you get invited for a national game.
Their fear is, I guess, it gives them a leg up on next year.
But then,
already getting to play. But how many seniors are on this team that don't matter?
That won't even be back. That's ridiculous.
But you know what the other thing is? I hate to say, it could be about the money. The state's not getting any collection.
That might be it.
Yep. Think about
that
it.
That might be it. I follow the money in every decision made. On about anything.
Well, I could get them some money. If they would tell me if you go, it's going to be $1,000 fine, I would just raise the money and give them the $1,000.
I mean,
it wouldn't be nothing for Myers Park.
Oh, yeah, I was about to say Myers Park. I'm sure.
It wouldn't be nothing for Myers Park to raise that money.
My thing is, if they really wanted to go, I mean, they could go. I mean, they're really going to stop them, you know? I'd put them on a bus, find somebody that might sponsor them for the cause, and just be like, all right. I am out of here.
And I'd like to know what what the penalty actually would be
you know,
if it did happen. And you know, and I will say this too, a lot of ADs and coaches are really loyal to NCHSAA and just not going to do anything to buck the system. If they tell them they can't go, then they're just going to bite their tongue and just not go and play in it.
Now, a minute ago, you was talking about that 1A school. We talk about this a lot, whether or not the prep schools and the charter schools should be in the same conferences with the public schools. You talk about Winston play the prep team, the boys team won, got beat. The girls team won.
Yeah,
now, guys,
ugly.
I saw the Cherokee girls up in Cherokee.
And you were amazed by them.
That may have been one of the best passing. I mean, it was like watching the Globetrotters play, the way they pass the ball, guys, mm-hmm. and move the ball. This All-Star team, they have four girls on it. Okay, the coach is the head coach of the All-Star team. They got an assistant coach that's on this. These girls can play. When we walked in Winston-Salem, David, to see Winston-Salem Prep against Cherokee.
Yeah. Yeah.
What was the score?
Oh, it's 50-something to something team.
It was almost at the mercy roll. 54-13.
54-13 or something like that, guys. Just make up a number that just sounds outrageous.
And, you know, we just instantly thought, wow,
Cherokee must be blowing somebody out. And they were getting beat.
Yeah.
This is one of the best teams I've ever seen for a girls' team. I mean, they just passed the ball layup after layup. And best of mine, I had a bad game, but come on. I mean, that was a good passing. That was a good team. And they beat Bessemer by 50.
Which
kind of
tells you Bishop McGinnis has been dominant till this year. They've won 9 in a row in 1A till this year. How long before we see a public school win the 1A girls state championship? And how long maybe again before we see
a boys school win it?
East Carteret was tough all year. They went wire to wire with maybe one or two losses all year and were really good, and I heard a lot about them. But to know they knocked off Prep after the way Prep had dominated. So and we may not see a team like East Carteret again.
So if Cherokee beat Bessemer by 50, and they got beat by 50 by Winston-Salem Prep. So Winston-Salem Prep plays Bessemer City Girls 105-5. And they're a playoff team. They're not even a bad team. They're a playoff team. So, I mean,
hey,
come on.
Makes you
wonder. Got to fix something. I mean, it's just, I don't know. I don't think it's right or fair. I'm not saying anything bad against them if they have their own league, champions and everything. It's just some things aren't fair. And you got two different set of rules.
And then, once again, if you're going to let the private schools play in the public, put them in the 4A.
But then the 4A's would buck it. I mean, they would argue it. Would you not?
It'd be hard to argue it as a 4A school when you got 4,000 students and they got 150.
We finally got Charlotte Catholic up there. we're their 4A numbers now. So hopefully their numbers won't drop that back down. They are playing 4A. But, tough, just a tough situation. But congratulations to all the state champions.
Congratulations, yeah.
And congratulations to East Lincoln and Ashbrook.
East Lincoln photos.
And the Hickory girls.
And from that game are on Facebook. And we'll have a replay with our audio. You can watch some highlights. We're still working on some highlights we're going to put up. You can always watch our highlights and our broadcast from the year on YouTube.com/WhatsUpShopper or KTC Broadcasting.
Back with more sports talk in a moment. Born and raised in South Detroit. We're community-minded. We believe in what we do. We love this town. We live in just like you.
We're a community bank. That's why we always try to approach things from a community-minded point of view. When something is in the best interest of the communities we serve, it's good for us as well. We're community-minded, just like you. Carolina Trust Bank, member FDIC. Community-minded, just like you. We're community-minded, just
like you. Hello, this is Milton Baker, and I'd like to invite you to join me in Big O Country for a live remote broadcast this Saturday at Red Rabbit 27 in Lincolnton. It's the Hop in the Spring this Saturday, March 21st, the first day of spring. There'll be lots going on at Red Rabbit 27, free hot dogs from City Lunch of Lincolnton, plus chips and soft drinks too. We'll have door prizes and lots of giveaways from Big O Country and refreshments too from Red Rabbit 27. Get Easter flowers and plants. Bring the children out to pet the live Easter bunnies. You can even purchase a live Easter bunny that day. Red Rabbit 27 has made lots of changes to its appearance, too. A newly redesigned showroom, new vendors with everything from antiques to children's attire and more. So come on out this Saturday, March 21st, from 11 a.m. to 1 p.m. for the live radio remote broadcast at Red Rabbit 27. And Red Rabbit 27 will be open regular hours to serve you. Located on Highway 27 east of Lincolnton in the former Saunders Furniture Building. Hope to see you there.
Here's what's up in Cleveland, Gast, and Lincoln Counties. Brought to you by the What's Up Shopper and Big O Country, WHS, WCSL, and WLON. You can get free information about an accredited Bible college degree, associate, bachelor, master, or doctor degree. Contact Dr. Andy Royals at the Salem Baptist Church in Lincolnton at 980-241-4660. And Hospice of Cleveland County announces their annual chicken dinner and dessert sale Friday, March 27th from 3 to 7 o'clock at the Hospice of Cleveland County Administration Building. Cost is $12 per plate. Chicken prepared by Doug Fortenberry. And that includes a half chicken, slaw, pickles, baked beans, a roll, and a dessert. For more information, call Hospice of Cleveland County at 704-487-4677. And that's What's Up, brought to you by the What's Up Shopper, Big O Country, and KTCBroadcasting.com. For more information, go to WhatsUpShopper.com.
Here in Charlotte, our story is like no other. A while back, our city lost something, but we didn't lose hope. Our city fought, our city swarmed, and together we brought our team back. Back where they belong. We are the Charlotte Hornets, and this is our comeback. The home team is finally home.
Charlotte Hornet basketball right here at Big O Country and online at KTCBroadcasting.com. Before you spend thousands of dollars on new furniture, make your existing furniture look brand new with Carpenter's Furniture Upholstery of Lincolnton. Carpenter's Furniture Upholstery of Lincolnton has preserved family heirlooms in this area since 1967. Give your furniture a brand new look today. Give Carpenter's Furniture Upholstery in Lincolnton a call at 704-735-4667. That's 704-735-4667. And search Carpenter's Upholstery on Facebook. Casey DeMines and Joe Kay at Toyota Gastonia and Momentum Mazda invite you to come on in and see them for your new Toyota, Mazda, or pre-owned vehicle. Be sure to pick up this week's What's Up Shopper for a $500 off coupon on your next automobile. Good credit or bad credit, Casey DeMines and Joe Kay can help. Give them a call at 704-824-7777. Or better yet, drop by and take a test drive today at Toyota Gastonia at Momentum Mazda, 4821 Wilkinson Boulevard, Gastonia. Be sure to ask for Casey DeMines or Joe Kay for your best deal.
You care about the future of this community. You grew up here. You've raised a family here. Your life is here. So is ours. Carolina Trust Bank, Member FDIC.
Are you ready for the madness?
Harrison backs out with four, with three, a three on the left wing. It's good! Aaron Harrison's three with 2.3 seconds to play gives Kentucky the 75-72 lead.
The 2015 NCAA tournament is on. Westwood One. All the excitement of March Madness is right here.
The 2015 NCAA Tournament, right here on Big O Country, WHS, WCSL, and WLON.
And welcome back to Sports Talk. Full house in here today. David, Terry, Jason, Kevin, Evan on the board. Glad to have everybody with us Saturday morning. I think I see a little bit of sunshine peeking through outside. We haven't seen it much lately, and not likely to see it much this upcoming week either.
No, we're not. I want to mention one thing, David, as we come back. And the NIT championship, you know, is coming on. And I was watching it the other day, and Pittsburgh was playing. Mm-hmm. You know, I understand you didn't make the NCAA. But as a group of young athletes and fellow compadres that come to your school, I was very upset with how many people were in the Pittsburgh gym to watch them play at home.
Or lack of people in the gym.
Yeah.
Don't be mad at the people there, Terry.
There was probably more people pulling for George Washington than there was for Pittsburgh in their own gym. You know, and did Pittsburgh play bad? They did. So you didn't make the NCAA.
They were giving away blue chair suits as they came in.
I'm going to tell you.
They were there, they just looked like blue
chairs. Yeah, it was amazing. And they did get beat, but I was very upset with the fan support that Pittsburgh had. And them being an ACC school.
They usually have a good turnout to their games. They're usually passing.
Zoo.
They usually have a good turnout to their games, you know, especially in recent years. So. It's very disappointing to see that.
It was, and I was looking to see because I figure over half of them were on their phones, like another game I spoke about.
Lady at the Hornets game,
you know,
got busted in the
face.
What
night was that, or day, or
that was Tuesday night.
Tuesday night, yeah.
Okay, those students were at home watching the NCAA tournament.
Hey, it could have been, saying, well, this could have been us. You know, but Miami did win their game. They moved on with a 75-71 win over North Carolina Central, which North Carolina Central played them very tough all the way to the end.
So Pitt lost.
Pitt lost to George Washington, yes.
How bad?
About 6 points, I believe.
Yeah. Okay. Any other ACC teams in that tournament?
60-54 was the final.
Other than Pitt and Miami.
No.
We got
that was it. Here's the ones that's matching up that have moved on. Temple plays Georgia Washington today. Louisiana Tech against Texas A&M. Richmond against Arizona State. Herb Sendick. Alabama against Miami. Over on the other side is San Diego State beat Colorado State. That's kind of surprising. South Dakota State.
There we go.
Against Vanderbilt. Rhode Island plays Stanford. Old Dominion against Illinois State. And Murray State against Tulsa. And I'm going to mention one more team that showed up in the NIT that did not come to play, and that was Illinois. Alabama beat the living tar out of them.
Speaking of Illinois, did you notice? No, they were the higher seed, but they had to go on the road and play at Alabama. The reason is, second straight year that Illinois is having renovations done to their arena. But what does that say about your school? You're not having enough confidence that they're not going to play in the postseason tournament?
Exactly.
They have the mindset that they were going to get to the NCAA tournament and they had to worry about playing home?
I just happened to flip over to that one, and it was like 44-15. Alabama was destroying Illinois.
All right, that's NIT news. Real quick, guys, today Red Rabbit in Lincoln will have a remote. Milton Baker will be there with door prizes and lunch. Could get you a hot dog. City Lunch hot dogs are free, of course. So go shopping over there. Check out the DLC. Milton, he'll be there 10 to 2 today at Red Robert. We'll have the whole NCAA tournament today, of course, on KTC broadcasting the three stations. We will have a break on WCSL 1590 AM today from 4:30 until about 8:39. We'll be doing the All-Star game, the 1A All-Star game, the West versus the Midwest. Which will include a lot of 1A schools from around here, Highland Tech, Bessemer City, and Cherville. We'll have some players, boys and girls at 5, and boys at 6:30. Also want to remind everyone, if you're watching online, you can see we've got a table full of bunny rabbits here. It's Bunny with the Money time. Register to win $1,000 cash. Terry, you could use $1,000, couldn't you?
I'm feeding one right now. He needed some, some drink.
And see if the money comes out.
There's no money in the rabbits, guys. Don't shake down the rabbits.
Stab it and take his money.
Win $1,000 cash for the Bunny with the Money contest. Must be 18 to enter. There's plenty of locations around Cherville, Dallas, Falston, Gastonia, Kings Mountain, Ligon, and Mooresville. Ranlo, Shelby, Stanley, and Vail. Register at any one of the locations to know where they're at. Go online on ktcbroadcasting.com or pick up a What's Up Shopper, turn to page 10 of this week's paper, and there's a full list of where you can register to win $1,000 in the Bunny with the Money contest by the What's Up Shopper.
I don't want to mention one other tournament going on this week, the CBI and the CIT. Yeah, but in the CBI, Colorado, the two best teams played each other in the first round, Gardner-Webb against Colorado, and Colorado defeated them 87-78 to knock them out of it. But they'll face Seattle next. The Seahawks are coming to play. And then, the bottom portion has Mercer against Louisiana Monroe, Vermont against Radford, and Loyola Chicago plays Oral Roberts. But, again, in that tournament, I think the two best teams played in round one. And why they did that, I have no idea.
Are you in a CBI bracket there, Terry? Yes. It's filled out like you are.
Yes.
Winning that one.
Are you getting an NIT bracket?
I won
when
that
do you get into
one.
That?
He has a problem. He has a gambling problem.
On a sad note, I have to report the news that we lost Lincoln County lost a longtime educator, athlete, coach. Dr. Clyde Smith passed away on Thursday night late, it looks like, here, just reading a little bit about it. I was informed of this yesterday by a good friend, Kevin Ray, had let me know that Mr. Smith had passed away. Very familiar face for years and years in Lincoln County at different functions. Was speaking at Covenant Bible Church on Thursday night. Looks like he suffered a heart attack. Taken to CMC Lincoln and passed away later on after that. But I think he was at Stanley High School. Graduate of 1960, three sports star there, football, basketball, baseball, played football at Western Carolina, moved to Lincoln after that, was coaching under Von Ray Harris at Lincoln, and just a long, long coaching and principal, you know,
yes,
administration, just all kind of different things, and he will be missed, just a great guy. I see Wayne Howard has written a little piece about him here. You can see it on Facebook. And I like this part. He said, you've played the game of life well, my friend. Go enjoy your victory. I'll see you soon. So yes. Nice words there about Mr. Clyde Smith. And I hope that most folks had already heard about that. I'm trying to hide Jason's
spot. I want to say one thing about him. There was a few times that I almost got in trouble when I was in school.
Almost?
Yes, but
to be honest with you.
Yeah.
To be honest with you.
But a few times when I did, he would pull me over to the side, and he always had a gentle voice to be able to talk to you, and he'd straighten me out pretty quick, and it let me understand what I was doing wrong and what I should do. He'll be a guy that's really missed.
Yep, just a genuinely good guy, you know, just a genuinely good guy. So one of those people that you never heard anything negative said
exactly
about him. So just wanted to mention that, and I think not sure the arrangements have been set yet for his visitation and his funeral, but they will be set shortly, I'm sure. So a great loss, not just Lincoln County, but for everybody, everywhere, everybody involved. Last night, NBA scores, Orlando beat Portland 111-104. Philly beat New York 97-81. Is that the same Knicks that knocked off the Spurs?
Yeah.
Yes.
Brooklyn beat Milwaukee in three overtimes, 129-127. Cleveland over Indiana, 95-92. Miami over Denver, 108-91. Chicago beats Toronto, 108-92. Are you fighting a rat over there, Jason? What's going on? Oklahoma City over Atlanta, 123-115. Got me worried. Memphis beat Dallas, 112-101. San Antonio over Boston last night, 101-89. The Hornets fall to Sacramento out on the West Coast, 101-91. Golden State, 112. New Orleans, 96. The Clippers beat Washington last night by a score of 113-99. Now, I haven't checked this as closely as you guys have and been following it, but the first thing I hear this morning when I get here, if it ended today, the Charlotte Hornets
would not.
When I heard I got here was they
they're
would be.
Out. They're out.
So how quickly it changes.
We looked at the
standings.
How quickly it changes. But only a half a game.
Yeah.
Only a half a game behind Boston at this point.
Who'd you say?
Boston.
Okay.
The Celtics are in the eighth spot.
If you can't get past Boston, you need to quit.
But I will say this. The Hornets have the same amount of losses, so the Hornets just need to pick up a win. They would be tied. I have no idea what to break the tiebreaker if it came to that.
They play each other March 30th.
Got a feeling that
you'll be there, won't you?
Be some tiebreakers. There may be some tiebreakers used this year. For seeding, I don't know if it goes far down as to determine who gets in and who don't, but it looks like there will be some tiebreakers used as tight as everything is.
Well, it depends on who the opponents are. Like, if the Bucks somehow keep on falling like they have been, I think the Hornets will get that since they beat them in the series 2-1 this year. The Hornets also have a better divisional record than the Miami Heat. And I think they also – I don't know if they tied or if they are leading the division against Boston. I think they've won 3 out of 4, so I think they will – But so that will be a good thing for the Hornets if they do. It's just unless it's the Pacers that they struggled against the Pacers this year. And speaking of the Pacers, Paul George could be returning tonight or sometime this next week. So very big news for the Pacers, who have been doing an extremely good job these past few weeks.
Who, by the way, are tied for that 8th spot with Boston.
Would you rather have the 6, 7, or 8 seed?
6.
I'd say 8.
8 and face Atlanta. You think, yeah.
Me too.
Anything but 7.
I think the Hornets could beat Atlanta.
Anything but 7. Yeah,
I mean, Hal Horford don't want to deal with Al Jefferson for 7 games. Mm-hmm. I mean, he's a good center, but Jefferson's a little bit bigger. You have an advantage there at least.
Well, the Hornets have been struggling against guarding three-point shooters, and Atlanta has this little-known three-point shooter known as Kyle Korver. So
I
don't want to mess with that.
They'll put MKG on him and sit to run a box and one.
That's best case scenario.
See, Boston could guard him.
You mentioned Milwaukee. Yeah, they're lost
now,
8.
Don't tell
10.
Me they can't really, guard him. Yeah. You don't pick MKG second overall, then say he can't guard Kyle Korver. Now come on.
And
so
Atlanta,
he needs to be able.
You're talking about Atlanta being the one, and they're probably still going to remain the one even when it's all said and done. But they have dropped. More games, I think, in this last 10 than we've seen them lose all year. They've only won 6 of their last 10, so they are human. They're coming back down to earth a little bit.
They play Golden State on Monday night. You know, it was a matchup. Number one in the East, number one in the West, and Golden State won that matchup.
Yeah.
Where'd they play them?
At Golden State.
Out there. Yeah. Atlanta leading the way, 53-16. Cleveland is second, a solid number two team. Cleveland 9 games out of first. I just don't know if there's enough time for them to catch Atlanta because Atlanta's just going to win too many games.
And for Cleveland, if you hear David Blatt speak, the coach in title, he's all about them trying to maintain that number two position, you know, and trying to go for number one. Hear LeBron James speak, the actual coach on the team, he said it doesn't matter where we're seated at, just as long as we get in the playoffs, you know.
Also, just to go through these. Cleveland 9 games out. I just sat in here and realized, guys, there's actually only about 10 or 12 games left in the regular season. But Chicago is 11.5 out of first place, but just 2.5 out of the number two spot. But Chicago better watch their back. Toronto sneaking up on them, a half game out of the three spot at number four.
They played last night, and Chicago got the victory.
Well, it's big for them.
Yeah.
Especially not only to give them that half-game lead, but also to have another head-to-head win against Toronto. Washington's another one you better watch. They're just a game and a half behind the Chicago Bulls for the three spot. Then it drops off a little bit. You got Milwaukee, Miami, Boston, Indiana, Charlotte, and Brooklyn. And we could see any of those three of those six be the final three teams.
And as you mentioned, as you go from Milwaukee down, and they all have losing records.
Mm-hmm. Yep,
Milwaukee at number 6.
6, 7, 8.
Dropped some bad. It dropped some bad.
And
what's happened in Milwaukee? Why all of a sudden the 8 out of 10 in the loss column?
I don't really know. I mean, they've been doing just fine without, you know, Jabari Parker. And just at the trade deadline, they got a good deal with getting Michael Carter-Williams as a point guard. So, you know, I don't know if it's maybe because they're extremely young because – You know, you got the Greek freak, Giannis Antetokounmpo.
Say it again three times fast.
Giannis Antetokounmpo, Giannis Antetokounmpo, Giannis Antetokounmpo.
He meant Greek freak.
I think it's on account of Jason Kidd's finally started to coach.
Well, we haven't seen him do any antics this year, so that's good.
Whaley gets his cup of tea out there or whatever
is
he had to use as a prop. Western Conference, records look a whole lot better when you're 39-30 and you're at 8th It makes things look a lot better. But Golden State, just been the cream of the crop all year long.
I think they already clinched.
And they've won 9 of their last 10. Mm-hmm. So there's no let up in Golden State. 55-13, lead Memphis by 7.5, Houston by 9, Portland by 10.5. All three of those teams, along with the Clippers, have won 6 of their last 10. Mm-hmm. Clippers are 11 games out of first.
They got Blake Griffin back this past week.
Yeah, they did.
Did you read that article online about him shooting this year? He's shooting now more jumpers than he is taking it to the hole, and that's not what Blake Griffin should be doing.
He's tired of getting beat up. Yeah, that's what it is.
But they say he's improved
with
his jumper.
Body, come on.
The good news is he's improved his jumper, but now they was talking about, you know, comparing his dunks and his free throws, and everything's down across the board. Yeah, but he's probably like you said, tired.
Maybe
of
he's saving
proud.
It for the playoffs. Maybe. You know, and say, you know, I mean, maybe he is. Conserving some energy.
I gotta say, I think Golden State is just right now. They have to be the outright favorite. I mean, as long as they're healthy. I mean, I know the West is going to be tough all throughout, but I mean, they're just so hot.
Where the Spurs at, David?
Well, San Antonio's Spurs next. Is after the Clippers. They're sixth. They're tied with Dallas.
They're getting ready to pass the Clippers.
12 games back, and then Oklahoma City. City's just trying to hang on for their playoff lives.
Yeah. News came out yesterday. Sam Presti, the GM. Shutting down Kevin Durant for right now. They haven't said indefinitely. They haven't said if it's going to be for the rest of the season, but it's leaning that way. And you already have Serge Ibaka.
Yeah, out for 4 to 6 weeks.
Yeah.
So he's missing the rest of the regular season.
But I don't think they've got a choice. I mean, you're looking at New Orleans and Phoenix. They lose about every time Oklahoma City does. So, I mean, look, they've New Orleans is next. They've lost 2 while Oklahoma City's 1-2.
I think the
game
Pelicans
two.
Could possibly sneak in if Russell can't hang on to it by himself.
Yeah, and Russie had another triple-double last night. His ninth on the year.
He did.
Ridiculous.
But speaking of New Orleans, Anthony Davis, you know, the hype coming in, he's the third best player in the league, you know, coming into the season. Is it now, you know, a lot of people getting on LeBron, we're getting on Kevin Durant more recently. Not as much, but more recently. Is now the time we're going to start getting on Anthony Davis, although it's only year 3, you haven't got your squad to the playoffs.
That's true too. He's only year 3. He's only what, 22? So he could be a senior at Kentucky now, right now. Think about that. He could be a senior at Kentucky.
Oh man!
Oh, and they're only undefeated. They
one
can
thing
have
would happen
Davis.
Though if all these kids at the state,
they wouldn't have been there.
They wouldn't have the team they got now.
State might have accidentally got a recruit or two there, Terry, if he had went there. I'll tell you a funny bet real quick on Anthony Davis. After the national championship game, he scored 2 points. Right. In the national championship game, he had 2 points.
I didn't remember.
2 points. Did. Nobody will ever remember that, but he had 2 points. So I made the bet.
Good trivia question.
I made the bet that he would never, ever average 20 in a season, and the guy bet me $50. I lost that 50 last year in his second season. Yeah. I mean,
it wasn't by year, was it?
No, I was like, come on. A guy that scores 2 points, don't tell me he's the best player. He's got to score more than 2.
You haven't seen out. There was a video out. They have video of his jump shot coming into his rookie year at New Orleans. And then this summer, his jump shot, how they worked with the shooting coach and his form and his form and where he releases the ball. They had the picture. He used to release the ball in front of his face. Now they got it where he releases it above his head.
Got to get it up high. Mm-hmm. He reminds me a lot of, like, Garnett with better handle. You know what I mean?
And that's shot that he's picked up, that 15 to 17-footer that he likes to take. And remember, he played point guard in high school.
Yeah, I know. He was a guard. That's why I said he got that handle.
That's unbelievable. That's unbelievable. Is he the next face of the league?
Yes. Yes, he definitely
needs to shave the eyebrow to be the face of the league.
That's his trademark.
Yeah.
And remember,
he needs to get a little or a pelican tattoo, like right down the middle of it, like the beaker.
That would be like straight hand having his gap fixed.
And he's already the face. They already proclaimed him to be the face for USA basketball, especially coming up for the Olympics.
That's extremely big honor.
That might be
him.
Steph Curry by the time that comes up too.
Probably way too little, too late. But Utah is 1-8 out of 10. Another team in the West that's playing good. But just because they're so – I mean, if you look at it, Utah would be in the playoffs if they if they were able to play in the East. Yeah. Utah would be in the playoffs at 31-37 right now.
Yeah.
Because they're winning 8 out of 10.
For every Charlotte Hornets fan, it was tough watching that game, watching Gordon Hayward doing extremely well. They got a good group of young shooters, Rodney Hood, Dante Exum, Gordon Hayward, just good group of guys. And, you know, for the next couple of years, they just need a couple more pieces. They could very well be a playoff team.
They still have Derek Favors as well. From
Yes, I think they do.
Favors pretty good.
Yes.
Young, he's only like 22 also. I think he could be a senior at Georgia Tech.
Remember, while you said that, Smoke, watching Gordon Hayward, remember the Hornets, they offered him a contract, but Utah matched it. He was a restricted free agent where they could match any offer.
It was 5 years, $63 million, I believe.
And here comes Lance Stephenson. So you just it's hard to make moves in the NBA. There's only so many players that can actually make an impact.
Why are you talking about the OKC impact with KD?
Yep.
You shut him down for this season. Then he comes into next season, into the last year of his contract.
Yep.
And when the summer of 2016 kicks in, that's when the salary
cap
increase.
He's going to look good in the Hornets uniform.
The salary cap increase goes in, and you can look at a max player making between $30 and $35 million a season. That's why LeBron James only took a two-year contract.
Yep. I talk about Kevin Love. They'll
never let him get away, will they?
And Steph Curry and everybody else.
Mm-hmm. I don't know if OKC will ever let him get away. You can't let your best player, your franchise player, you just can't.
He don't
want to
be there.
Away.
You can't do nothing about it, though.
Yeah.
We'll take a timeout. Back with more sports talk here in a moment. There's not much time today.
Community minded, just like you. Community minded, that's for sure.
You care about the future of this community. You grew up here. You've raised a family here. Your life is here. So is ours. Carolina Trust Bank. Member FDIC.
Community minded, just like you.
Yeah. What's up, Doc?
That crazy rabbit is back with this year's Bunny with the Money. Someone will win $1,000 again this year. Register to win with no obligation to buy at Medical Center Pharmacy on East Academy Street, Cherryville. Amity Finance on East Ozark Avenue, Gastonia. Griffin Drugstore on West Mountain Street, Kings Mountain. At Family Auto Sales on East Dixon Boulevard in Shelby. You can also register to win at the Captain's Cap Family Seafood Restaurant on Linwood Road in Gastonia. At Parker Farm Service on Bessie Drive, Kings Mountain. At Honda of Shelby, Highway 74, Bypass East in Shelby. At Hillbilly's Barbecue and Steaks on Garrison Boulevard in Gastonia. At Summit Place on Pfeiffer Road in Kings Mountain. And at Sister's Closet on South Washington Street in Shelby. Register to win the Bunny with the Money. The drawing will be held Friday, April 3rd at 8:30 a.m. on Big O Country.
It's March Madness galore from IMA Residential Services, your Cleveland County train dealer. Check out these NCAA tournament deals. Buy a new qualifying train system and pay no interest until January of 2020. Or choose a trade-in allowance of up to $1,150. Spring in now for all the details, but hurry. This offer is too unstoppable to hide. Again, no interest until January of 2020 or a trade-in allowance up to $1,150. See IMA Residential Services for all the details. IMA Residential Services, 2409 South Post Road in Shelby, or call 704-481-1144. Looking for work? Tired of temporary job assignments? Then you need to see UltraForce Staffing Services in Gastonia, Shelby, and Lincoln. UltraForce Staffing Services is now hiring for permanent placement positions, including welders, machine operators, sewers, maintenance mechanics, metal fabricators, material handlers, and more. Start your new career today. UltraForce Staffing Services, 302 East Dixon Boulevard in Shelby, 915 North New Hope Road, Gastonia, and 518 North Generals Boulevard, Suite B in Lincoln. Visit your nearest UltraForce Staffing Services location today or go to ultraforcestaffing.com.
I'm Lon Helton, inviting you to join me as a countdown on the week's top 30 with Jason Aldean, who's having a whole lot of fun on the Burn It Down tour.
What if my microphone burst into flames, you know, and we had to dial it in?
Maybe Did you get singed while you were dialing it in?
Not necessarily singed, it's just a little hotter than I would like.
That's Jason Aldean this week on Country Countdown USA.
Country Countdown USA with Lon Helton, Friday afternoons 1 to 4, right here at Big O Country and online at ktcbroadcasting.com. It's hard to believe First Federal Savings Bank is celebrating their 75th year. It's all because of local people working and living right here in the community they serve. And they believe in giving back to the community by supporting our local schools, charities, and nonprofits. Services include checking accounts, savings, money markets, CDs, mobile banking, and online banking. with four locations in Lincoln, Bossier City, Denver, and our newest location in West Lincoln at the Shoals Road and Highway 27 West intersection. Online at ffsb-nc.com. An equal housing lender and member FDIC. That's First Federal Savings Bank. Bikes for the entire family can be found at Ride-A-Bike on the Court Square in Lincoln. Come see their line of family-oriented bikes with a wide assortment of recreational bikes. And remember, Ride-A-Bike in Lincoln repairs and services all makes and models. Specializes in Raleigh, Santa Cruz, LaPierre. Plus, you'll find a full line of cycling accessories, including clothing, shoes, helmets, and more. Get out and enjoy the weather with a new bike from Ride-A-Bike, 116 Northeast Court Square in downtown Lincoln. Open 10 to 6 Tuesday through Friday, 9 to 3 on Saturday. Call 704-735-1746. It's time to march into the camping season sale at Campers Inn in Kings Mountain. Camping season is here, and now is the time to march on in for thousands of dollars in savings with the best selection ever. Hundreds of new and used RVs on site with easy financing available. Brand new travel trailers start at $11,995. Big Class A motorhomes start at $69,900. See Brian Good today. The March into Camping Season sale is underway at Campers Inn, Exit 8 off I-85, Highway 161 South in Kings Mountain, where customers always come first. Do you have a lot of old medications piling up? Well, most people do. Then get rid of them and do it safely. Drop off your old medications at the new medication drop box located inside Falston Pharmacy in Falston. All medications will be disposed of by the Cleveland County Sheriff's Department. It's easy. Just clean out your medicine cabinet, bring them in the Falston Pharmacy, and drop them in the box. Falston Pharmacy, Highway 18 north of Falston.
We're a community bank. That's why we always try to approach things from a community-minded point of view. When something is in the best interest of the communities we serve, it's good for us as well. We're community-minded, just like you. Carolina Trust Bank, member FDIC. Community-minded, just like you.
We're community-minded, just like you.
Smoke Man on the board this morning. Glad to have you with us. As Kevin reported to us a second ago, it's still foggy outside, so be careful.
Sunny and foggy, though.
Sunny and foggy.
What a combination.
Sun, just if you can just do this and part the fog a little bit, you'll be able to see the sun. It's supposed to be a sunny day today, and looks like maybe the forecast for the rain the next couple of days has led up to maybe just some cloudy days, maybe some rain along the way, but maybe not the all-day rain. That's what we're trying to avoid, as we've had so much of it here within the last 6 weeks or so. But indoor sports are going fine. Your mm-hmm. basketball is going fine. But the outdoor sports, the softball and the baseball, not quite as much.
Let me make
point.
A few quick announcements here. In the What's Up Shop every week, Calvin Hastings is a sports report, basically congratulating people that make accomplishments, local athletes. Couple of quick notes just from the article this week. Crest Chargers named their head coach, Will Clark. Defensive coordinator, plays Mark Barnes. WC Friday middle school basketball team won their fourth straight championship, now with a 34-game winning streak.
Wow.
Shelby middle school beat Crest in the middle school boys game. In the girls game, RS Central down Crest 41-24. That's the Tri-County middle school. And let's see, former Lady Jaguar of Forest View, Bree Armstrong, named to the All-Georgia College Athletic Association first team. She plays for South Georgia Tech. This is news that you usually don't hear from around here. Gardner Webb's basketball player going pro. Hey. Jerome Hill averaged 18-10 this year. He announced he's going to forego on his senior season to enter the NBA draft.
Have they had any since Artis Gilmore?
You don't hear much? Yeah, no. I don't know. Dan Greer probably
has. I they have had any in between.
Excuse me, and let's see. Let me quick through that. Might be Lincoln and defensive end Tyron Roberts signed with Winston-Salem State,
yep. Right.
And Gardner Webb, football coach, will be the guest speaker at this year's Cleveland County FCA Sports Hall of Fame banquet, April 27th.
Go ahead, and Jason. Then one other announcement. You know, those are seen in the news and newspapers this week. Chaz Surratt had knee surgery
right.
for a torn meniscus tore meniscus back last summer at Chapel Hill there at a camp, doing a standing broad jump. And wow. he played through football and basketball.
He only got beat once. Yeah, and was named the Southern Piedmont Player of the Year.
In football and basketball. Yeah, MVP
player of
the Year.
Player of everything.
Biggest news this week on the local high school front comes in basketball. Wes Caldwell, head basketball coach Danny Anderson, steps down, and now the new head coach at Maiden. So one of the most winningest coaches actively in the state of North Carolina is going to Maiden to coach the Maiden basketball program.
Terry's got a hall pass.
And yeah, I got a hall pass. Another thing around our area for our coaches and stuff, the Region 6 state games are being held in June, and Coach Alan Chapman has been named as one of the assistant coaches for a baseball game that will be held in June of this year.
Congratulations to him as well. Going to go to the telephone lines now. We've got Butch Parker. Speaking of Maiden, we've got Butch Parker on the line. How are you this morning, Coach?
I'm doing great. First of all, is Terry pissed off at everybody or what?
He stays that way.
He's being petty.
My word, I love the guy. And I come in here.
He's still very, very tense from the one-point victory Wolfpack got on Thursday night. He's still very, very tense. Coach, can you turn your radio down a little bit?
I turned it off. How's that?
Well, that was a good move. You wanted to hear us. But I
turned on this morning and listened to Terry rant and rave about Duke being a one seed. I'm like, my God, it's only happened about 12 or 13 other times.
They deserved it then.
I don't know why they when you're at the level state is when they're kind of sucking them third tits. He gets on you a little bit.
He's got fire in his veins this morning. He's just in here to disrupt things this morning.
I still love him, my life. He's the best in the business, and I still love him. Hey, we got a baseball game down here today, and I want to just tell people about that. Couldn't get the field ready yesterday. It was just a little mushy, kids are playing well, and baseball's, rocking the first day of spring. Good day to play three or four or whatever and have hot dogs and come to Maiden High School and watch the Bandits Trojans. Play a little baseball with us. I'll talk a little about that basketball in a minute, but I don't know nothing about it.
Rivalry game, Bandits and Maiden today.
Yeah, it is. Like I said, I think we got to share first place with them Rebels down there right now, so I know our kids want to hang on to that. And that type of thing, and make something happen down here. And like I say, get outside, it's going to be a beautiful day, supposedly, when this fog lifts, if it ever does. But so they can get that thing tuned up and shined up and spiffed up and hear that man say, play ball.
Play baseball in the
fog. Come on, man.
It's an adventure for the center fielder, adventure for all the outfielders. Hit one up into the fog and say, there you go, boys. Find it.
You got it. But Well, JV started at 12. The varsity's going to go at 3. We got full service varsity blue concession stand, hot dogs and hamburgers from Don's Grill, Papa's Pizza to go, and of course, my smiling face behind the counter. What more do you need, huh?
That's about it.
I had a bout of bronchitis this week, and I didn't get to work a whole lot. And, Coach Bliss called me and said, just going to get your heads up on some stuff going down. And got down there Thursday morning, and he asked me if I'd write up a release and stuff, and he gave it to me, and I said, okay. and it did bring Danny Anderson to Maiden. Pat Connie stepped down, and Coach Bliss and Danny are longtime friends, and Frank Snyder's friends with Danny. And Kane Hauser's maestro this whole thing through, and those basketball people are kind of jacked up Maiden right now. I mean, I understand it. I mean, you bring a man like that on campus, and things ought to happen a little bit. You know, we just been kind of one of those muddled around basketball teams that never really jumped out. A couple of years we had some good teams here and there, but nothing consistent, which is what you look for in a high school program. And after I talked to Danny the other day, when I asked him if he had lost his mind, and he assured me that he hadn't. And I think things are going to be okay down there.
You know, I think one of the biggest questions is from around the area, and I'm not sure we'll ever know the real answer, is why Coach Anderson decided to part West Caldwell. He'd been at West Caldwell for so many years, a tremendous coach there. As I said, probably got to be in the top 10 in wins in the state, at least in active coaches, because he's done so well with West Caldwell. Taking him, I think, to three state title games, most recently, I think, is 2012 maybe, where they lost to Kinston, believe it or not. But and just steps down from that program where he's been, you know, a fixture for so long.
Well, I'm dare not going to speculate on people's personal decisions. And I didn't talk to him about it and that type of thing. And in my capacity, mate, it's not any of my business. But I tell you what, now this is, and this is a trend that's troubling me, because I'm afraid I'm falling in it. Is if you start looking over the last 10 years, and one time an old guy told Tom Brown, he said, his name was Babe Howell, you know the name, he was a great coach. He said, don't ever mention the word retire. Don't ever bring it up till you're just absolutely sure you're finished. And you know, you look at a lot of these old guys, older guys that have been in the business, you know, there's a lot of unceremoniously leaving of schools by those people. Right. I don't like it. I ain't gonna lie to you. And again, when you look at that, I'm talking about Harold Robinson at Williamson. I'm talking about Babe. I don't know about Kenny Ford's deal up there. I mean, he might be getting ready to go out on his terms and all that. But a lot of old coaches are kind of just been kind of shuffled off to Buffalo, if you know what I mean.
Yep.
I think that's not a good thing. I don't think that's a good thing. But, again, that's a day when it's ugly and raining, we can discuss later. Because I'm excited about Danny coming to Maiden. And, again, you know, somebody else's misfortune has opened up my school fortune, and that pleases me. But, you know, Danny had his reasons, and you know, you do what you do, and you're the only person that knows, so. We'll welcome him and see if we can get some wins.
And rightly so. You're getting a good coach, not only a good coach, but a good man, from what I understand. I mean, every time I've been around him, just a class act, presents himself well, and he will definitely present Maiden basketball with the utmost class.
I think so. I really do. And that's the way I know Danny. And you know me, I don't ever mince words, which gets me in a lot of trouble, but. Yeah, first thing I heard from a couple people was, well, I got Maiden football. And I'm like, where's it going? And they said, well, you know, Danny doesn't let his players play football. That's a lie, you know. And he's not going to come in and say, we're going to build a basketball program, we're going to kill a football program. And, you know, that's not going to happen. And people that talk about it are just foolish people. But they're going to. They have fun with it anyway. But we'll see. You know, we'll see where it goes, see what happens.
It's very interesting news. As I said, it was one of the bigger high school stories around this week. And I'll say congratulations to Coach Anderson coming there to Maiden. Congratulations to Maiden.
I'll give you a heads up, Peter, if I didn't know. I knew it was happening. I just didn't know when it was happening. And I couldn't text. I had bronchitis affects every muscle in your body.
That bronchitis affects my texting.
Yeah, I ain't what you call the most. I ain't Energizer Bunny by no means, but buddy, that'll knock you flat to the ground. And it came at the end of a beach trip while I was still at the beach, so I was just like brutal. It was double brutal. But anyway, hey, have a great day. It's Saturday. Let's play some ball, watch some basketball tonight, and y'all can go back talking about the NBA because I'm out.
Sounds like a winner, Coach. Hey, we appreciate hearing from you today. Have a good one,
buddy. Have a great day, guys.
All right, Coach Butch Parker there, Maiden. Mm-hmm. Just want to throw this out there, guys. 644-216.
Wow.
Danny Anderson, 644-216. Been coaching basketball since 1982. Three-time state runner-up, 94, 99, and 2010. I didn't go back quite far enough. 2010 is when his team lost to Kinston. He's just ran a tremendous program up there. And Maiden losing a good coach, too. Patrick Connie stepped down after getting his 500th win this year as well. But Danny Anderson, well-known in this area and well-known statewide for his basketball coaching and just the stability of a very good program at West Caldwell. We're going to stay right on the phone lines now. Coach Scott Harrell, Cherville High head coach, on the phone with us. Coach, how are you this morning?
I think smoke's still getting connected.
All right. We're working on that connection right now as we speak with Coach Harrell. Coach Harrell, whenever you hear me, if you can hear me, let us know. Anyway, I'm sure Coach Harrell's calling in to talk about the All-Star Games today, going to be taking place here at Cherville with the 1A West All-Star Girls, the Midwest All-Star Team and Girls, and then the Boys Games to follow. And we will we'll check that out and see what all Coach Harrell has to say about it. Kevin explained to me the 1As just don't get quite the notoriety as some of the bigger schools do, and it's a chance for these kids to showcase their talents on a bigger stage today.
Yeah,
Coach, are you there?
Yes, sir, I'm here.
All right. Well, last Saturday I saw you, but it was from about, 500,000 feet away, and all we could do is wave. I was on one side of the court and you on the other. But
that was a fun day at the state championships.
It was a fun day. I'm sure it was. I'm sure you enjoyed watching some very, very entertaining games. And before we get going and let you talk about this, what did you think about that Kinston squad after getting to see them play?
Well, they were probably the best team that I saw down there all day long. They were athletic from 1 to 5, and I know Ingram gets a lot of attention, but he sure did have a lot of help on that team. They're very good.
Yeah, and I was impressed that they just didn't try to use him for every single thing. I mean, they, you know, other people touched the ball on every possession just about, and, you know, he would touch it on about every possession, where if I had him on my side, he would touch it on every possession. But he gave it up a lot. I mean, you know, he had a tremendous all-around game, not just the 28 points.
That's the truth. And you could tell that team worked well together, and they didn't just stand around and watch him play. They were all a part of it. And, you know, any level 1A through 4A, I really thought they were the best team in Chapel Hill last week.
Yeah, they were good enough, Coach. They could have made a run. I don't know if they'd have won the state title, but they could have made a run deep in the playoffs if they don't have Brandon Ingram on their squad. That's just how good they were through about 12 players.
They were. But it's a good day. Anytime, you know, East Lincoln made it to the state championship, Ashbrook was there. You know, that's a mighty feat in itself. And I was proud to watch those guys, and I know all those coaches. So it sure was fun to watch it from up top. A lot less stressful, but I know it's a lot better to watch it from that coach's seat on the court side.
I'm sure it is. Coach, I'm sure you gave us a call today to talk about what's going on this afternoon in Cherville.
Yes, we got some 1A West versus Midwest, the inaugural All-Star game that we hope now will be an annual event. We get to host the first ever one here in Cherville. Dr. Bud Black kind of organized everything for us. And we've got practice this morning with the Midwest squads at 11, and then the Western squads from Murphy, Cherokee, Robbinsville, Hazeville, Rosman, all those Western schools will come down. They practice at 12:30, and then we got a banquet at 2:00 for all of them there at First Baptist at the COC. We'll have a meal and a banquet for all the players and parents. Then the girls' game starts at 5:00 and the boys' game's at 6:30. So we're hoping it's a fun day. We've had a practice or two with the guys, and it sure is fun coaching those guys. That you get them out on the court, it's like they've played together even though they've never been together.
Yeah, it's good to see kids from all over Western North Carolina getting together to play in this basketball game today. And I think I was going through the list here, Coach, got one of your own going to be playing in this All-Star game.
We do. We've got two, actually. Ryan Davis and Grant Henderson both will be playing today. And we're excited for them and the opportunity for them to get to play in this. And, you know, for seniors, the last time you put on that uniform is pretty difficult. And for some of these seniors that get the chance to put on a uniform one more time and go out and play, it'll be a fun night for them.
Yep, several high schools. We mentioned this a little earlier. I don't know if you were listening this morning. We talked about all the different high schools that are being represented today, which is also very good. Obviously, you got Highland Tech being represented, Bessemer City here locally, Thomas Jefferson, Pine Lake Prep, Lincoln Charter, and then outside our area, Mitchell, Avery, several Avery, Swain, Cherokee, Hiawassee Dam, Murphy High. A lot of teams that you're familiar with. And when the playoffs roll around, you get used to seeing these names.
We do. We've played a lot of them, and you develop relationships with all those coaches over the years. And when you go to the playoffs, coaches always make phone calls to other coaches. So, you know, it'll be a good day. A lot of those coaches will be down here watching their kids play, and it'll be fun to catch up with some of those coaches, because in the coaching business, you know, you develop a lot of friendships, even though you're hundreds of miles away from other coaches. You get to see them a couple times a year at clinics, and it's good to see them in person. So.
Well, I think everybody's looking forward to it, Coach. An all-star game, a lot of talent. Just going through some of the stats here, there's some big kids, some big boys going to be playing in this game, and some really high scorers as well. I mean, I see so many guys in here that, you know, averaging 17, 18, 19, 20 points a game, things like that. So, you know, it should be entertaining to watch.
Yeah, it should be. You know, I'm fortunate and blessed to get to coach this first game. And through the practices, we worked a lot on the secondary break and pushing the ball up the floor, which was new to a few of them. But they all seemed to enjoy it in practice, knowing that if we passed it four times, somebody better be shooting tonight.
Coach, it sounds like a fun day at Cherville today for the two All-Star games, the girls and the boys. Before we let you go, I got to ask you a key question here. How's your bracket?
All of them right. Would that be the correct answer? Well, no, mine got busted, I believe, the first day with all those upsets. I did try to make a smart move, and I picked Kentucky to win it all.
Yeah, well, probably 75% of the nation or more went with Kentucky to win it all. And, you know, a lot of people think that they might run into somebody that can beat them. But the funny thing is, only one team can play them at a time. And anytime they go up against somebody head-to-head, they're going to be the favorite. And they have such a good squad, you know, that one or two guys might be off that night, not playing their best game. But that when you go 10 or 12 deep, it really helps. And they're probably going to be able to overcome it.
It is. That's the greatest part about college basketball, and I think it's the greatest sport on the college level as far as the NCAA tournament, though. It's fun. Everybody has a chance to win. You know, look at the upsets you saw on Thursday and Friday, mm-hmm. and people didn't think those teams would win, but just that one given night and that one given chance to have a good game, that's what makes that NCAA tournament so special.
Yeah, I'll tell you how good it is. I'm proud of my record. I'm 24-8, but I am not proud of one particular bracket where I only got three of the final eight in that bracket right.
and that was the upset bracket.
That is that SMU Iowa State bracket where I picked St. John's. I went out with upset. I picked Eastern Washington to beat Georgetown. Not happening. I was picked with my heart with Davidson. Didn't happen. So yeah, that bracket's ugly.
That bracket didn't work out too good, did it?
It did not. It did not. But
I tell you what, a shout-out to our baseball team at Cherville High School. They're off to a fast start right now in the season.
I heard a lot of good things about them, Coach.
Yeah, congratulations to Coach Evner and his staff, and those kids have worked hard. I tell you, it's fun to watch them play. They're a group that's really already knitted together this early in the year where they're really cheering for each other and have a lot of excitement that you don't always see at the start of baseball season. You normally see it toward the end of the playoffs, but hopefully they'll have another special season this year. They're looking good so far.
Who are these two big, strong pitchers I'm hearing about on that squad?
Well, you got Austin Mosteller, a big left-hander,
mm-hmm.
And then Randall Long
mm-hmm.
Is doing really well for them. Noah Aker, a 10th grader, he has several saves on the year. They're using him more as a closer. He comes in about the fifth or sixth inning and shuts him down, and I know that makes one of the radio announcers, Danny Aker, really proud.
No doubt.
But they're doing really, really well. Jimmy Johnson is just doing super at the plate, leading the team in hitting. Austin Mosteller's got three or four home runs. So it's kind of a total team effort. Hunter Jackson's kind of the captain of the defense there at the catcher position. He was 4-for-4 the other night. They've just got a lot of kids contributing right now, and it is fun to watch those guys play.
You know, we got a lot of good baseball in the area too, Coach, and that makes for fun and entertaining games and rivalry games. And you know, we talk about our sports in this area. We've had a good run of football and basketball the last couple of years, but baseball's right there too each and every year. We always have some teams go deep in the playoffs.
It sure is. I mean, we've got a lot of good baseball teams around here. And, you know, Scotty's played a lot of good teams already early here with playing Crest and North Gaston and East Lincoln. And
beating, you know, those teams.
And beat those guys. Yeah, he's had a good start here to the season.
Coach, sounds good, buddy. We appreciate it. Appreciate you giving us a call
this
morning.
I'm sure you told everybody that the game will be on the radio tonight, and if they can't come out to the gym, it will be on the radio, and I think it'll even be on What's Up Chopper.
Yep, you're exactly right. You'll be able to watch it live and also listen to it live, but we encourage folks to come out and see the kids live and in person.
There you go. All right, David, I appreciate it.
Thank you, Coach.
Take care.
Coach Scott Harrell there. I did get to see him last week over in Chapel Hill at the game, but as I said, saw him from a long distance away and just never got to make my way across the court to get to talk to him. But good for him. Glad he's getting the coach today in that inaugural East-West, or I guess West-West, West versus Midwest All-Star game. Very good. Looking forward to the game today and giving these kids, most of all, a chance to show their talents.
Exactly.
Show their talents on the big stage. So.
Dave, before we go to break, you see the news on Twitter, legendary Philadelphia Eagles.
I saw that just now.
Chuck Bednarik passed away today.
Yep.
89 years old.
You know, he's well known for his football, his physicality, the way he played football, mm-hmm. and probably his most famous hit was on Frank Gifford one time during his day. So, yeah, we lost a great one today in Chuck Bednarik. 58, played 58 minutes in the 60 NFL title game, which is all of them plus, right? All of them plus the overtime. So, very impressive. Nowadays, you see everybody come off every play for mm-hmm. a break. He played on both sides for the entire game. We'll take a timeout. Back with more sports talk in a minute.
Hello, this is Milton Baker, and I'd like to invite you to join me in Big O Country for a live remote broadcast this Saturday at Red Rabbit 27 in Lincolnton. It's the Hop in the Spring this Saturday, March 21st, the first day of spring. There'll be lots going on at Red Rabbit 27, free hot dogs from City Lunch of Lincolnton, plus chips and soft drinks too. We'll have door prizes and lots of giveaways from Big O Country and refreshments too from Red Rabbit 27. Get Easter flowers and plants. Bring the children out to pet the live Easter bunnies. You can even purchase a live Easter bunny that day. Red Rabbit 27 has made lots of changes to its appearance, too. A newly redesigned showroom, new vendors with everything from antiques to children's attire and more. So come on out this Saturday, March 21st, from 11 a.m. to 1 p.m. for the live radio remote broadcast at Red Rabbit 27. And Red Rabbit 27 will be open regular hours to serve you. Located on Highway 27 east of Lincolnton in the former Saunders Furniture Building. Hope to see you there.
Here's what's up in Cleveland, Gaston, and Lincoln counties, brought to you by the What's Up Shopper and Big O Country, WHS, WCSL, and WLON. The VFW Post 9811 at 3800 Margrace Road in Kings Mountain is having a community Easter egg hunt on Saturday, March 28th at 1 p.m. There will be hunts for children ages 9 and under and prizes in every egg. Happy Easter from the VFW Post 9811 in Kings Mountain. And the Beaver Dam Baptist Church Men's Barbecue Mission Trip Fundraiser will be held Saturday, March 28th from 4 to 7 p.m. It's all-you-can-eat barbecue pork with all the trimmings. A $10 donation is requested, and children 6 and under eat free. Carryouts will be available, plus Boston Butts for $35. For more information, call 704-692-4514. And that's What's Up, brought to you by the What's Up Shopper, Big O Country. For more information, go to whatsupshopper.com. For over 100 years, the Stamey Teisinger Funeral Home in Falston has been providing services to families of our community with care and compassion. And now the Stamey Funeral Home has added the Cremation Center along with a new name, the Stamey Teisinger Funeral Home and Cremation Center. The Stamey Teisinger Funeral Home and Cremation Center on Highway 182 in Falston and the Stamey Funeral Home in Cherryville, located on Dixie Street in Cherryville, serving you with care and compassion in your time of need.
In the nation, we're here for you. From first cars to second homes, from the terrible twos to the golden years. Nationwide, we put members first. Join the nation.
Nationwide is on your side.
Your Nationwide insurance agent in Cherryville is Sandy Cunningham Nationwide Insurance, 1608 East Church Street. Call 704-445-1990.
Subject to underwriting guidelines, review, and approval. Availability and details vary.
Nationwide Mutual Insurance Company and Affiliates, Columbus, Ohio.
Never before has the NBA seen a story quite like ours.
Oh, penetration score!
Never have basketball fans seen their passion bring back the same team with the same name to the same place. These are our Hornets. This is our comeback. It's Charlotte Hornets basketball, and you can hear it right here on this Charlotte Hornets radio network station.
Charlotte Hornet basketball, right here at Big O Country, and online at kdcbroadcasting.com.
68 teams, one dream, one champion.
Rebound to Ryan Boatwright. That is it. From underdog to top dog, the seven-seeded UConn Huskies go wire to wire for their fourth national championship.
Westwood One is your home for the NCAA tournament. Catch every bounce basket and buzzer beater right here.
The 2015 NCAA Tournament right here on Big O Country, WHS, WCSL, and WLON.
I'm right over here with it. Easy there. Great.
Rates are low today. The time is right to improve your home. We have home improvement loans and we're lending right now. Join your neighbors and friends and people all over our local communities who are improving the quality of their lives by improving the quality of their homes. We're an equal housing lender. Carolina Trust Bank, member FDIC. Community-minded just like you.
Nah. What's up, Doc? Well, that crazy rabbit is back this year with a bunny with the money. Someone will win $1,000. Register to win with no obligation to buy at the Great Outdoors on Highway 150 East in Cherryville, at Falston Pharmacy on Highway 18 North in Falston, at Flooring America on Slater Street, Kings Mountain, at Carolina Hardware and Garden Center on the Reevesville Road in Lincolnton. You can also register to win at Amity Finance in downtown Mooresville, Bill Schuford Heating and Air Conditioning on Campbell Street in Shelby, at West End Sales on Highway 18 North in Vail, at Energy Direct on South Lafayette Street, Shelby, at Gasland USA on East Dixon Boulevard in Shelby, and at Love's Fish Box on Highway 74 Business West in Kings Mountain. Register to win the Bunny with the Money. The drawing will be held on Friday, April 3rd at 8:30 a.m. on Big O Country.
Ringing in your ear.
That was Terry talking. Glad to have you with us on a Saturday morning here on Sports Talk, final segment of our show this morning. NCAA tournament coming up today. What time does your Tar Heels play basketball?
8:40.
Sure is.
And that's the last game.
State plays at 7:10.
The Notre Dame-Butler game is the last game of the evening.
So we do know that much. State's at 7:10. Mm-hmm. Carolina's at 8:40. Mm-hmm. What about
Notre Dame Butler is, I think I want to say, is 9:10, 9:20, something like that.
So okay. Just wasn't sure about the schedule for today because when I pull it up here. It
starts
just
off with UCLA, UAB. Well, I don't blame them for that one.
12:10, UAB, UCLA, 2:40, Cincinnati, Kentucky, 5:15, Ohio State, Arizona, 6:10, Georgia State, Xavier, NC State, Villanova, 7:10, 7:45, Utah, Georgetown, Arkansas, Carolina, 8:40, and Butler, Notre Dame, 9:40.
Most interesting, let's leave our teams out. Most interesting matchup today and tomorrow.
Today?
Wichita State, Kansas.
Yeah, that's for
that's
tomorrow.
An in-state rivalry, yeah. And Wichita State's wanted to play them for years, and Kansas just mm-hmm. has tried, for whatever reason, avoid the scheduling. We'll find out today, maybe. But
we have nothing to gain.
They have nothing to gain, and Wichita State has everything to gain.
Another
you know?
I mean, Carolina don't play. I mean, there's a reason these Carolina schools don't go up to the mountain and play Appalachian or used to
and
back in the day.
Wichita State, if they lose, they can go with the where we're supposed to lose. You're Kansas, and
exactly.
If they win, it's like we knocked off the mighty Kansas.
Another in-state rival game tonight: Butler Notre Dame.
Butler Notre Dame.
I think
battle
that
of Indiana.
I think that one's going to be an interesting one because Butler is usually the team that plays Cinderella. Mm-hmm. You know, they were just so close to winning it 5 years ago. And, you know, Notre Dame struggled against Northeastern.
Yeah.
So, but I want to say something. I think Notre Dame is the only team in that bracket that can beat Kentucky because of the shooting the three. Kentucky does not guard the three well.
Notre Dame is not very big, so it would definitely have to be by way of the three. I am mad at one ACC program, and just going to mention that for a moment. They should be better than they are each and every year, and that's Georgia Tech. Georgia Tech's right there in the heart of Atlanta where you can just pick the cream of the crop out of your town and get your players. We got Georgia and Georgia State, which are not even basketball schools, in this big dance. Georgia State even won a game. Yep. Georgia played Michigan State real close. And where's Georgia Tech? I mean, they're outside looking in. We're supposed to be the best program, and they're on the outside looking in at these other Georgia schools go to the big dance. And
well, they don't play in the ACC.
And congratulations for them. You're right. I mean, that's a lot of their losses. But, man, I wish I could go and pick out of Atlanta.
Yeah, the talent. Yeah, you can just recruit that city alone.
It should be able
you
to. Should,
you can have an all-star team. You
oh, I agree. But you have to understand in the SEC, you got Kentucky and then the rest of the crop. That's how it is in basketball. And if you can be a second or third team like Arkansas, Georgia, and them teams, then you're going to get in.
I didn't even agree with Georgia getting in. You know. I mean, I looked at their wins and losses, and it just didn't look like a good enough resume to get in. But then they played Michigan State pretty close. I mean, a pretty good game, but that, you know, that still doesn't mean you should get in. But Georgia Tech, they just kind of let us down. I just think the school deserves to be a little better in basketball than they are.
Best video from Thursday was the Georgia State game, the comeback that they had in the game on a 12-0 run, capped off by R.J. Hunter's three, the go-ahead three. And his dad's Coach Ron Hunter, who's sitting on the sideline. He tore his Achilles at the conference championship.
In the first celebration.
Yeah, celebrating there. And so he's got a cast on. He's sitting in a rolling chair on the sideline. His son hits a three, and he falls out of his chair, and he go to Vine and YouTube.
Yeah.
It's all on YouTube.
And look like he got sniped. Yeah. He's a funny guy. Have y'all seen any of his other interviews and stuff? Yes. Oh, he's hilarious.
Well, back to the conference tournament in the semifinals game, they interview him after the game, and he was talking about his son. RJ goes off, has a good game. He said, "What about your son?" He goes, "Yeah, he's pretty good, but he's not even the best player in this household."
he said he told his wife that if he knew RJ was going to be this good, we'd have had more. His son just sits there and just shakes his head during these interviews because his daddy just says funny thing after another, and his son just shakes his head.
He's talking about horse. Did you hear him talking about playing horse? He said, "Have you ever?" Bellis asked him the other day in an interview. Said, "Have you ever told your son you might want to step in? That's a little too far out, you know." And he said, "Yeah, playing horse." When they're playing horse against each other, I thought that was a really, really good answer to that question. Kentucky, Cincinnati today. Who you got?
Kentucky. Cincinnati. What a comeback they had Thursday.
Yeah, everybody can say them at one time. I don't know if I hear something different. Maryland, West Virginia. That was going to be Sunday.
Maryland,
West Virginia. No Huggy Bear. Butler, Notre Dame.
Butler.
Notre Dame.
Notre Dame.
Wichita State, Kansas.
Wichita State.
Kansas ain't going to let it happen.
I'm going with Kansas, too.
They ain't going to let it happen.
I'm with it. And Kansas is better than people think they are.
Man.
Wisconsin, Oregon.
Wisconsin.
A sweep. Arkansas, Carolina.
UNC.
Carolina.
Xavier and not Baylor. No. Georgia State.
Xavier. Too physical Xavier, underneath. Yeah.
Toss up, really, though, right?
Xavier, I guess.
Name two players on Xavier.
And
all you got to do is see them play. Very physical.
Can Georgia State be the surprise team this year? No. Get to the Sweet 16.
I mean, Florida Gulf Coast was kind of like this a couple years ago.
There's going to be a 14 or 11 seed in the next round, no matter what. UAB, UCLA is playing first.
Well, I'm going with UAB because that is the next head coach of North Carolina Tar Heels.
But in order, Ohio State, Arizona. Haas. Jason Haas.
Arizona.
Jarrett Haas.
Arizona.
Ohio State, Arizona. Yeah. Everybody likes Arizona. Yeah. Watch out for the Buckeyes.
Yeah, D'Angelo Russell. Kid.
I'm not a fan, but watch out for him. NC State, Villanova.
Villanova.
You know, Terry, you picking
Come on, Wolfpack.
I'm going to be honest, Terry. I picked one. I did do one bracket, and I did it online just by myself. I didn't enter anything. For an upset pick, I picked NC State to beat Villanova.
Well, I'm going to be honest with you. I went
back
the other night, and I put the stuff out there, and it was 81.3% that LSU let us win.
Let you in.
My trigonometry all come in, and I figured it up. And it was 81.3% because you can't miss six straight free throws. You can't go since the 9-minute mark without hardly scoring.
State
has no chance in this game.
It's hard to pick against Villanova the way they looked in the first round.
Jay Wright.
Northern Iowa. Duke. Why can't you beat Villanova? They're number one seed.
That's right.
Northern State has no chance.
And Louisville.
Louisville.
I'm a State
Louisville.
Fan.
I know.
I picked Louisville too, but
I got Louisville.
I think Northern Iowa is going to win the game.
That's I think Northern Iowa will. They played spoiler about 5 years ago.
Playing Northern Iowa. I'm going Northern Iowa.
Northern Iowa's
I'm afraid
just a better
Louisville
team.
Going those droughts and they can't score.
Yeah, but Louisville's going to play defense where Northern Iowa can't score too.
Dayton, Oklahoma.
Ooh, Oklahoma. That's ooh.
Well, shoot, hold on. The way the Big 12.
I'm
gonna
say
going.
Dayton.
Dayton.
I'm going
to
go with Dayton.
I'll go with the
one of them play-in games.
Michigan State, Virginia.
Michigan State.
Go ACC. Let's go Virginia. I think they can win the game, but it will be tough against a good Michigan State team. Duke, San Diego State.
Duke.
Yeah.
San Diego State surprised me. I thought they were, and they may beat Duke, but I thought they were better than they were. They didn't look real good.
When does Duke actually enter the tournament, Terry?
Did win the.
Yeah.
What?
At a wrong seed.
Utah and Georgetown.
Utah.
Where's it at?
Georgetown looked good
Where's
the other
it at?
Night.
Where's it at?
It don't tell on my bracket. I wish
don't
it did.
Either.
It is.
Because there's so many different sites that they just don't list them all. We got to move through here again real quick. We're about to run out of time. No SMU, no Iowa State. We've got UCLA and UAB.
Unreal.
Initials.
I'm going UAB. Like
going
I said,
Dragons.
UCLA.
Future head coach of North Carolina Tigers, Gerard Hayes.
UAB's pretty
Bruins.
Good. UAB's pretty good. And we also got Gonzaga. And Iowa.
How in the world this happened? Gonzaga wins.
Yeah,
I think
Gonzaga.
The Zags win too. But if Iowa plays like they did last night, whew, it's going to be pretty tough.
I think Iowa. I've seen them play a couple times. I think they're pretty underrated, so I'm going to go with Iowa.
Here's your deal. Duke will win, Utah will win, and then Duke's out.
Duke loses to Utah?
Yep.
Very well, kid.
Keith Van Horn playing.
Or Andre Miller. You know, Andre Miller's still in the league. He's still in the league. He's 38.
They got eligibility left.
He's in Sacramento.
Terry Weed is not legal in the state of North Carolina at this point.
Speaking of real quickly, you know, Hampton played Kentucky the other night, and there was a great tweet out saying, these five guys enrolled in Hampton because they have never played college basketball. It was LeBron James, Kobe Bryant, Dwight Howard. Who was the other two? Gosh, there was two more NBA players that went straight to high school. Kevin Garnett, and I'm trying to think who was the other one. I can't think of the third, think of the fifth
Big
person.
Message here before we go. Tim Pruitt says, kicking camp today at Cherville. Kicking camp here. 14 participants making their team better in March. Cherville High School, Ford, Shelby, Bessemer City, and Kings Mountain are represented today. Kicking camp at Cherville. Last word says, it's always football season. Thank you, folks, for tuning in today.
Go Pack.
Keep up with the NCAA tournament, as well as all your high school sports. And don't forget the big all-star game today over at Cherville High. Things getting underway at 5:30, right? 5:30 first. 5 o'clock. 5 o'clock. Girls game starts at 5. Boys game 2 following. Check it out. Thanks for tuning in. For Terry, Kevin, Jason, and the Smoke Man, I'm David. We'll see you next week on Sports Talk. Take me home. Take me home.